Ladies and gentlemen, we're broadcasting worldwide on this 24th day, 2015 global transmission. It is Friday, the 24th day. And of course, we'll be back this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central Standard Time as well with the Sunday transmission. And then next week, I haven't announced this until now, and we'll have details Sunday. I will be traveling to Europe to track the collapse of the Eurozone into the expanded one-world government. And I will be broadcasting, co-hosting with David Knight, and filing special reports starting in the middle of next week and into the next week from Spain, from Greece, from different areas of the EU, and basically going and getting a firsthand look of it, at it for myself. We have Steve Quayle joining us to break down the latest on Jade Helm and other paramilitary activities and what's happening to the world economy and what the big event is that so many elites are gearing up for. And then Jim Mars will be in studio, best-selling New York Times best-selling author, researcher, JFK professor, taught the first national level course on it. Population control, how corporate owners are killing us. Jim Mars, best-selling author of Rule by Secrecy and the Trillion-Dollar Conspiracy. Bad air, bad food, bad drugs, bad energy, bad water. I know he's pro-gun. We'll find out what he means by bad guns here on the cover. Wall Street Journal had to say, think you know what's going on? You don't. Jaw-dropping. So that's coming up. But first, Obama was already out demonizing the Second Amendment and putting out this info yesterday ahead of the shooting where two people were killed in a theater. You would think, watching the mainstream media, that it's the end of the world. Hour after hour after hour of press conferences, Governor Jindal. I mean, you would think that an asteroid was coming to destroy the Earth because it's a theater. The whole world's a stage. Each of us players upon it. And now we're hearing in the news again, don't ban guns, ban white people. Because another lone nut drifter reportedly shot two people and then himself. Here's President Obama.
If you ask me where has been the one area where I feel that I've been most frustrated and most stymied, it is the fact that the United States of America is the one advanced nation on earth in which we do not have sufficient common sense gun safety laws, even in the face of repeated mass killings.
Killings.
If you look at the number of Americans killed since 9/11 by terrorism, it's less than 100. If you look at the number that have been killed by gun violence, it's in the tens of thousands. And for us not to be able to resolve that issue has been something that is distressing, but it is not something that I intend to stop working on in the remaining 18 months.
Man, it's hard to listen to him. You saw that little gleam in his eye in his remaining 18 months? He is coming after the guns. We're going to play that clip when we come back and analyze it piece by piece, because the whole thing is upside down bizarro world. Switzerland has more guns than we do, and they have lower crime. The areas with guns have low crime. We're 330 million people. Mass shooting violence is down. It isn't guns killing people, it's people. It's just all lies, every stinking word of it. It's already Friday, the 24th day of July 2015. I'm your host, Alex Jones. Steve Quayle's joining us also, Jim Mars in studio. I'll break down more at the bottom of the hour on why those guests are joining us, but you're not going to want to miss it. And of course, we'll be back live this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. I am your host, Alex Jones. There has been another shooting. A lone drifter from Alabama in Lafayette, Louisiana, reportedly shoots two people, and you would think that a major city just blew up. They are all over the news saying it is the fault of the Tea Party, the fault of conservatives. They are all over the news saying, come on, not one more life, take the guns. When you go to New York, Chicago, D.C., the places where they've taken the guns, they have the highest crime rates in the country. In the case of Chicago, the world, 40-something people a week, almost all of them black, get shot in Chicago. What is it, about 15 a week die, and 90-plus percent of it is black on black. There is almost zero discussion of that because the citizens can't stand up for themselves and are just fed on by the criminal element. It is racist that since the end of the Civil War in the North and the South, the first gun control laws were put in at city levels to keep black people from being able to own guns. Well, I'll be you know what if I'm going to have a black person owning a gun. In the North and the South, they passed laws that blacks couldn't have guns, and so the criminal element always gravitated to those neighborhoods because they knew people couldn't protect themselves. It was a group you could push around. Just like the Asian mob, whether it's Japanese or Chinese or Taiwanese, pick on people in their neighborhoods. The Italian mafia 200 years ago, 150 years ago, was just street thugs that would shake people down at their vegetable stands and their hardware stores, and then grew into what we saw in the 50s running the country. And it's the same thing for the Mexican mafia feeding on Hispanics and all the different MS-13 different variants. And it's the black criminal groups, heavily armed, feeding on black people. The exact same story over and over again. Arm the mothers, arm the fathers, blow the punks away, like's been happening in Detroit, where the police chief said people need to arm themselves, the black police chief. And they've shot a whole bunch of thugs, hundreds of them, and guess what? Suddenly crime's going way down in Detroit because they don't have a bunch of strict gun control. And even though it's very poor and has collapsed, its crime rate is going down. Look it up. Because the criminals are scared to carjack or home invade because they get laid out with lead. But this is how they can make a mountain out of a molehill. Two people are dead. It's very tragic. Upwards of 100 people die a day on the highways. Are we saying ban cars? Two dead, six wounded, a gun-free zone. Well, Paul Watson has the article, Infowars.com. Don't blame all Muslims for Chattanooga, but blame all conservatives for theater shooting with no evidence yet that this guy was a Tea Partier. But Tea Partiers on record, Justice Department's own numbers, conservative libertarian people have the lowest crime rates out there in studies and the highest level of charitable giving. Look it up. Just type conservatives, libertarians, highest level of charity study. Type in Tea Party, lowest crime rate. It is a fact. People self-identifying as conservative or constitutionalist or libertarian have the lowest crime rate. But if you watch mainstream dinosaur media, when they're not telling women to have special devices so that they can pee standing up, or telling women to show they're feminist by having green or purple underarm hair. By the way, will you give me the New York Times and Yahoo? People don't believe me when I mentioned it yesterday. This is the top stories. Have green underarm hair. Pee standing up if you're a woman. White men are inherently bad. Whites are criminals. Whites are dangerous. And you sit there, MTV, New York Times, MSNBC. It is crazy town. And then out of 330 million people, there's just crime and murder going on by the hundreds every day, because that's what's always happened. Overall crime since 92 is down 61%, according to Professor Lott. The Justice Department says 51. Whatever. Let's just say 51% drop. 51% drop since 1992. And you would believe there is a insane epidemic of people swinging from chandeliers, shooting everybody. And the only place that's happening is the south side of Chicago, New York, D.C., as some bad areas of Dallas, Houston. I mean, every major city has bad areas where there's a bunch of drug dealers and criminals and all the rest of it. And that's what goes on in those areas. And the criminals gravitate to those areas because they can get away with it. They can then go out of the crime area, rob the middle class, rob the suburbs, rob working class folks, and then come right back into their warrants. And that's what's going on. And there's, you go to those neighborhoods, there's white scum, there's black scum, there's Hispanic scum, they're all scum. In their feeding on good people and poor people that live in those areas. And scum all acts just the same. They just got different color skin. And so, I mean, I was there this morning and I watched for like 30 minutes. And then I came back and watched another 30 minutes. I was on the elliptical for like 25. Then I was halfway watching it while I was lifting weights. Then I watched it for another 30 minutes getting ready. And I never saw any information, just the police acting like it was the end of the world, the governor acting like it was the end of the world, everyone just acting like it's this giant, spectacular theater event. I mean, if a chemical plant blows up and kills 50 people, it's on the news for a couple hours. If there's a highway pileup and it kills 100 people, it's hardly even in the news. If bad stuff gets in the water, you know, and it kills 14 people, it's not even in the news. But if two people get shot in a theater, oh my gosh, we're defenseless in a theater, a shooter could pop up any minute and kill us. It's creating the perception that imminent death could happen at any minute. And why is a Republican governor playing along with this in Lafayette, Louisiana? What is he doing within hours of it in breathless press conferences? It's bizarre. But it shows how mainstream media has lost its credibility. It's falling apart. Its ratings are declining steadily. But still, it can put on a hoax. Still, it can make something like this the top story. And Obama, in a chilling 58-second clip, part of an interview with the BBC we're going to analyze here in just a moment, has this wicked gleam in his eye. And he goes, I'm frustrated I haven't gotten the guns. He goes, but I'm going to really make some changes in the last 18 months. Obama admits U.S. gun laws are his biggest frustration, close quote. And he doesn't talk about 51% drop in crime using guns. He doesn't. Now, the economy's starting to unravel, so crime's actually starting to go back up. But that's because of collapse. But it's still nothing compared to 92 levels and the whole crack war. And he just implies that we're the only country that hadn't had the guns taken. No, Switzerland hasn't had their guns taken. He's guarded by guns himself. He has bodyguards, and he sits there and implies that the guns are going out and attacking the people, and no word about almost all of the, quote, mass shootings. Over 90% of them, Justice Department's numbers, are gangland shootings, just like with the mob in Chicago in the old days, with the Italian mob shooting up the Irish mob or vice versa, or the Jewish mob shooting up the Italian mob or vice versa. You would watch this and you would think there was just an epidemic, just like they do with shark attacks. There have been more than 50 attacks this year with small sharks thinking your foot is a fish and biting it. There's been a couple deaths. And I saw articles just last month that it's cutting back on beach profits for hotels because there has been a little bit of unusual level of shark bites, still very low, and people are scared to death. You got a better chance of a leprechaun jumping out and giving you some gold, having a great white shark attack you. But people think they're about to die any minute. Let me tell you who's dying, because they count criminals getting shot as people killed by guns in the news. Most of the people killed in crime statistics are shot by the police or by citizens shooting criminals. And you can find a lot of bad cops out there, sure. Society's degenerated, but most of the shootings are completely justified when the police are being shot at. And there's thousands of cases of citizens aiding the police with firearms to pin people down. Guns are the answer. They're not the problem. Let's play this Obama clip one more time, then I'm going to come back and play it slowly and just every second stop it and go over the lies. Because no one can lie as a tissue, as a compendium, as a continuum, as a body of frothing, stewing baloney. Filled BS like Mr. Bravo Sierra, Barack Hussein Obama. Let's go ahead and go to it.
If you ask me where has been the one area where I feel that I've been most frustrated and most stymied, it is the fact that the United States of America is the one advanced nation on earth in which we do not have sufficient common sense gun safety laws, even in the face of repeated mass killings. And, you know, if you look at the number of Americans killed since 9/11 by terrorism, it's less than 100. If you look at the number that have been killed by gun violence, it's in the tens of thousands.
And the guns did it.
For us not to be able to resolve that issue has been something that
now watch his eyes.
Distressing.
He's coming.
But it is not something that I intend to stop working on in the remaining 18 months.
Oh, well, that's creepy. We're going to go to break and come back. I'm going to play the clip and just take each lie. There's one thing he said in there that was true, though. Did you catch it? One little kernel of truth.
If I could have gotten 51 votes in the Senate of the United States for an outright ban, picking up every one of them, Mr. and Mrs. America, turn them all in, I would have done it.
One thing that I think is clear with young people and with adults as well is that we just have to be repetitive about this. It's not enough to simply have a catchy ad on a Monday and then only do it every Monday. We need to do this every day of the week and just really brainwash people into thinking about guns in a vastly different way.
And we're going to play more of those clips today where the president, the vice president, and others during the campaign in 2008... 2007 promised that they weren't coming after semi-autos, rifles, shotguns, handguns, anything. And it was a complete conspiracy, a total lie that they owned guns. They believed in the Second Amendment. And how dare anyone say they were going to try to get our guns? I've got Obama saying it more than 30 times. We've got Biden saying it dozens of times. I know, because I was going to put that in the Obama deception, too, that I never finished. Maybe I should just play minute after minute of their lies. It's like saying, you can keep your doctor, it cuts your prices by half. Well, first, Obamacare was going to be free. They're just such predators. They're protected by guns. They've disarmed people all over the world. And now they want our guns. And now they want Switzerland's guns. Switzerland has the lowest crime rate in Europe. Look it up. Yeah, England has low gun crime because they absolutely have a ban there. They're an island. But they have 3 to 10 times, depending on what numbers you look at and what region, the muggings, the stabbings, the beatings to death. So, yes, you get beaten to death or stabbed to death 3 to 10 times more often, and their crime rate is at least double on average in the United Kingdom what it is for the U.S. national average. What we have is pockets of hellish crime. Very small, hellish pockets. And we need guns in those pockets, because what's not in those pockets? Legal citizens with guns. That is, citizens that are able to have guns legally. They follow the law. They get preyed upon. They're mainly poor black, poor white, poor Hispanic Americans. And it's despicable. Now let's go over this clip of Obama chilling, because he's coming for the guns. The Social Security folks, if you wire transfer money, that means that you supposedly are inept. And what's the technical term the FBI memo uses? That you've been found incompetent. So they're not just going to say you're mentally ill because you go to a psychologist. Or because you're depressed. No, no. They're taking your guns. And if you don't like it, you won't get your Social Security. Just like the IRS is now taking people's money and their paychecks and their refunds for Obamacare fines. They promised that wouldn't happen. They are a pack of criminal scum. Now let's start playing the clip here, and I'm going to talk over his lies, but we'll be stopping it. Here it is.
If you ask me where has been the one area where I feel that I've been most frustrated and most stymied,
pause.
It is the fact that the United States of America is the one.
You know why he feel stymied? Because we at least get the physical holding of weapons to defend ourselves. We at least understand that. But he's still done it outside of law. So in a way, that's a lie, because he's getting a lot of it done, and they're brainwashing our kids, suing the gun manufacturers, death by 100 cuts. Then he goes to lie and says we're the only country where they haven't taken the guns. There's actually 4 or 5 that still have some rights. Only the U.S. and Switzerland that have pretty strong rights. Let's go back to the next lie.
Advanced nation on earth, in which
he implies you're advanced if you don't have guns.
Common sense gun safety laws.
Common sense,
even in the face of
common sense, says if you have more guns, there's less crime, and areas that have gun laws have the highest crime. So it's another lie saying it's common sense what you're doing. Another deception. Please continue.
Repeated mass killings.
Let's pause again. Repeated mass killings. There's a couple hundred people die a year in mass shootings, and over 90% is gang-related. One group shooting another group. And you notice when that happens, it's hardly on the news. You know, like 20 people get shot in Detroit, 5 or 6 die in a gang shooting, or Chicago, and it's not even just a blip. But man, one old white guy goes in and shoots 2 people, it's the end of the world, it's the Tea Party, they're coming to get us. Let's continue.
And, you know, if you look at the number of Americans killed since 9/11 by terrorism, it's less than 100.
All right, let's hit pause. Then he goes on to say it's thousands by guns. Well, guns didn't do it. Criminals with a tool did it, or insane people. And a lot of the folks that you talk about getting killed were criminals that were killed when folks defended themselves. So lie within lie. But there was some truth there. Let's back it up 15 seconds. When we come back, we'll play a rare happening. A true blue moon. Obama told the truth. This is stunning. Stay with us. So Obama says something truthful here in the clip. And that's that we've only had 100 people killed by terrorism since 9/11. Yeah, so why are they taking more and more of our liberties constantly in the name of countering terrorism? And then how 15 years after 9/11 is the Wahhabist movement out of Saudi Arabia bigger and more powerful than it has ever been? And is now taking over Egypt, Libya, Syria, and parts of Iraq with our government's blessing and support. And why isn't ISIS attacking us more if they hate us so much? Because they're controlled by the West. They are directed by the West. And they do have camp followers and bots and useful idiots that aren't in on the conspiracy who do occasionally attack. And that's why when they do attack, the government keeps it very quiet, and the media does, because that doesn't fit into the narrative. There weren't hours of press conferences last week, 8 days ago when those Marines got shot. CNN for 3 days kept saying, why would he do it? He was all American boy. MSNBC said, probably a conservative. And of course, he said he was doing it as a jihad. And then that's seen as anti-Muslim. No, I'm not anti-Muslim in general. I'm anti-radical extremist being funded by the globalists and their camp followers attacking us, and then the media won't cover it because it doesn't fit into your narrative. So let's go back to the Obama clip where he says he's coming after those guns. Here it is.
Of repeated mass killings. And, you know, if you look at the number of Americans killed since 9/11 by terrorism, it's less than 100. If you look at the number that have been killed by gun violence, it's in the tens of thousands.
Dead pause. And most of them criminals being shot or criminals shooting criminals. The vast minority people being killed by criminals with guns. And then in the aggregate overall crime rate going down with guns, as gun ownership by good people and proficiency goes up. And then he sits there and acts all upset and concerned. Just, he can't keep us safe. He really wants to help us. When NATO and Obama and Hillary Clinton on record funded Al-Qaeda, now known as ISIS, to kill more than 80,000 people, they estimate now, who were innocent, not even combatants in Libya. Tens of thousands upon tens of thousands, unknown numbers. In Egypt, hundreds of thousands in Syria, somewhere over 350,000, hundreds of thousands in Iraq, whole families executed, gays thrown off of buildings, churches blown up, priests killed, beheaded, Alawite, non-radical Muslims, or they're really more like the Alawites or the Sufi Muslims aren't even what I'd call Muslims. They're like Jewish mystics, Babylonian mystics. It's like King Solomon stuff. It's more Masonic. Oh, they find them, they really hate them. It's a branch of the Shiites, and that's what Assad is, and that's why they really want to get him. That's why he doesn't make women wear bags on their heads or sexually mutilate them and wants women to go to college and have equal rights. So they got to be killed. Is Obama up there talking about that, how he's so concerned, the hundreds of thousands killed that he supported, or the Muslim Brotherhood connected to it all? No. Or groups connected to him attacking shopping malls in Nairobi, Kenya? No. It's all fake bull, and I'm just sick of it. But let me tell you what this signifies. They are coming after our guns, and they are fully capable of staging a massive false flag at a shopping mall, at a grocery store, at a public school, at a college, and killing hundreds and just showing the dead bodies and saying, see what you did, gun owners. You are guilty for this. Now, by the guilt, submit to us. And they attached the rebel flag to a mental patient who was on an amnesiac. I predicted, I said, if he's on an amnesiac, it may be staged. Sirhan Sirhan was on an amnesiac. Came out in the police report, it was staged. LAPD. Just look it up. Shooting of RFK. You can't make this stuff up. And there's no telling. The theater shooting. He was on drugs, on amnesiacs. When they wore off, he said he was set up to the police in lockup, told people next to him in the jail cell. Then the media came out and said, oh, actually, he was never in an area to talk to folks. But the prisoners went public and said, yeah, he was there. And he was in a DARPA classified mind control program under the top Air Force psychiatrist, one of the top ones in the country that commanded air bases before and then became his basically handler and met with him hours and hours and hours and hours multiple times a week. And he was getting upwards of $85,000 a year of government funding for a secret project with DARPA, with brain interface. We reported it back at the time by searching his name. It was in the Denver Post and in the L.A. Times a few months ago with his trial or whatever. You know, it came out that he was part of a government brain research program. Oh, yeah, he sure was. Just like Theodore Kaczynski, the Unabomber, just type it into a search engine. Theodore Kaczynski worked for the CIA, and you'll get Atlantic Monthly, you'll get LA Times, you'll get Associated Press. He was in the CIA MK Ultra program, not for 10 years, not for 20 years, but for close to 30 years. His family said he disappeared into CIA mind experiments. Oh, there's nothing to look at here. There's nothing to research here. Let's all just move along. CIA at Harvard. There it is. Harvard and the making of the Unabomber, Atlantic Monthly. But they just act like it's a coincidence. No, it's not. Tim McVeigh, highly decorated, goes into special ops, gets sheep dipped. So they take you and put you into a spy operation. They even had mainstream news articles about how he was sheep dipped. He said, I will not be. He wanted to set up right-wingers that were going to bomb a building. They were going to wind up the white supremacists at Elohim City, run by the Southern Poverty Law Center to do it. Terry Nichols is on record. I've talked to other folks that were on death row with McVeigh in basically phone calls that they didn't even know were going to happen to this show. You've heard it live. And the police involved, FBI and others who've exposed it. And when they said, no, we're going to go ahead with the bombing, just like Ahmad Salam, Egyptian security, said, I'm not going along with the bombing of the World Trade Center in 93. We've had him on. He's a listener. McVeigh said, I'm not going to really bomb a federal building. We wired this up to set him up. And they said, all right, buddy. And then that morning, they drugged him. And he was found on the side of the road, crawling around on the ground with no license plates, foaming at the mouth, saying, it hurts, get the chip out. There's a chip in my butt. That was in the newspapers. But it's like, oh, he was foaming at the mouth on the side of the road with state police reported saying, I got a chip. I mean, whether he had a chip or not, I don't know what was going on. I mean, this is all cloak and dagger stuff. What I told you is what we know. And I've interviewed Jane Graham, who was one of the top people at HUD, who would walk up the back stairs, wouldn't take the elevators for exercise, and saw what she said were a lot of really good-looking, serious men. I mean, she said she was a younger woman at the time. She said, these are really good-looking men. Yeah, one of them was famous German intelligence. According to her, it's the guy we know flew out of the U.S., had a Southern Poverty Law Center lawyer, I should add, that came to his defense. Famous fella. Well, the other side of the Southern Poverty Law Center, the guy that played the part of the guy, on the other team. And she said, what are you doing? They were putting big gray sticks of butter and wires in. They said, we're from the telephone company, honey. And she identified them on the news. Some were FBI, some were ATF senior, and the other was German intelligence with McVeigh. And she was there. She even talked about it. Why are they doing all this? I mean, they wired a building in front of everyone with federal IDs. And then McVeigh's like, okay, let's bring the white supremacist in. Let's set them up. And they went, no, we're going ahead. And he said, I'm not blowing up a daycare center. Oh, really, McVeigh? Well, guess what? You'll fit the bill, the evil right-wing soldier. And the truth is they've been casing militias all over the country, and he'd been at Waco, too, on who they were going to set up next as part of that Pentagon project. So for all the military personnel, all the special forces people who have shown up at my events, who have threatened me, this is years ago. They don't do it anymore. Guess they can't find folks that'll do it, that have tried to set us up. Just remember, and remember well, that you could be on one of these operations someday and that you could be set up. So you just remember that. You just remember when they're getting ready to blow up a federal building with a daycare in it, that you might be the one they set up, Buster. And I know you know that. You're just going to really serve the evil and hope you're not the one they pick. Because that's how we win. Machiavelli, end justifies the means. Really, what's the end? To put veterans on don't treat list and kill them and kill old people and abort babies? And bring down the country and shut down humanity? I mean, why would you want to serve this? Because you get incrementally put into it. You start running drugs. You start doing assassinations for the government, for the criminals that run it. And next you're being told, blow stuff up, be part of these operations. And the only reason we haven't seen more Oklahoma cities is we're on their butt. They know the local police departments have all seen Oklahoma City bombing cover-up films. They've seen my show. They've heard the interviews. I mean, I've been in police departments multiple times. And the police chief or the SWAT team head or whoever will get up and say, Alex, I don't need to hear all this. I know. And we'll open their cabinet up, and it'll be my videos, other people's videos, and John Birch Society literature. And they go, we know what's going on. Thank you. Have a nice day. So can you imagine how it is for the globalist who want to pull this off? And now everybody knows about false flags. I mean, we had two lawyers on a plane from Amsterdam with the underwear bomber who gets led onto the plane drooling. So he's looking at him with a sharp-dressed American, and they're going, he doesn't have any ID. And he flashes ID and says, you know, basically national security. They go, okay. They let Mutalib fly. He gets up basically, you know, stumbling around peeing on himself is how it was basically described. Once they're getting ready to land, and a firecracker goes off in his pants, and they announce, we're putting in body scanners next month. We just ordered them. They'd been ordered a year before when Chertoff was still at Homeland Security. He then goes, becomes the head of the company where he ordered them a year before, and himself gets $20-plus million off $3 billion. The CIA puts a drugged person on the plane with a firecracker in their pants, and so we all now get to have our genitals grabbed. Do you know how much it scares them? That they know our people are everywhere watching everything. And later it came out in Congress. Haskell's questions, he and his wife's points were brought up. And the head, the deputy head of transportation, Mr. Kennedy, said, yes, it's true. An unnamed agency told us to let him on the plane. I'm going to say that again. An unnamed agency told us to let him get on the plane. I didn't mean to go off on a whole jag about false flags. It's just that we don't know what they're going to pull next. But Obama had a certainty in his eye. Criminals always tell you what they're going to do. And he said, I'm coming for the guns in my last 18 months. And let me tell you, I can feel it in my gut. I can see it. And that might be the false flag that when they come for the guns, people will start shooting back, and then the whole civil war kicks off, and this is just a disaster. This is horrible. They're going to try for it. They want to wreck the country. They're shutting the nation down. They are breaking our families down. They are shutting down our industries. They are Obamacare is meant to bankrupt the country. They are going for broke right now. And it is so sad. And listen, they have to take over and have authoritarianism in their view because they know they can't shut the internet off till they've done that. They can't curtail it till they've done that. And now Planned Parenthood is coming out saying, brace yourselves, they're going to have racist videos where we're celebrating killing blacks and minorities. And brace yourself, they're going to have us dissecting babies and selling their parts. They've got undercover video. That's right, the Patriots do. And by the way, it doesn't matter what you do, criminals. Go ahead and try to shut the internet off. Go ahead and try to arrest us. Go ahead and blow up a federal building and blame us. We all know the truth. And so the signal's been sent, and everybody understands what's going on. And people should be burning copies of this show on DVD, because when they shut stuff down, if they do, we're trying to stop that. Folks will kill for a copy of this show breaking this down. Because you see, here's why they got to shut us down. As everything we've warned of begins to manifest, as it already is, the credibility is going to go from high to stratospheric to messianic. And I don't mean myself, but the liberty message, the resistance to evil is messianic. It is the answer to the evil. And when stuff gets hellishly dark and hellishly cold, folks are going to want to warm their hands by the fire of truth. And truth flows through the universe from the beginning of time into the future. It can't be turned off. It can't be suppressed. It's like trying to hold a beach ball down on the bottom. But here it is, backlash. I'm going to get into a whole bunch of these reports. Planned Parenthood expects undercover reporters to release video of clinics harvesting baby organs. They're going to show a highly sensitive area in the clinic where the tissue is processed. Yeah, we're going to humanize that tissue that you don't want us to look at. And don't you think you can win? You'll never shut any of us down. My heart and soul knows that the worse it gets, the stronger the people that love the truth are going to be. Evil is evil, and wickedness in those that serve darkness is absolutely pathetic and weak. But it intimidates us into bowing down to it. I'm going to go to break. I said that we were going to have plenty of the new product. I ordered double of the new product, thinking that we tend to sell out of stuff so quick when it's first offered. I ordered double what we usually do a test run of Dr. Group's proprietary, didn't even make it for himself, highest quality, total 75 different herbs and minerals and zeolites combined together to create deep cleanse, the ultimate super antioxidant, and so much more. We sold 45% of it yesterday in 24 hours. And we will definitely sell out of it by Monday. So if you want deep cleanse, InfoWarsLife.com. We'll get more in September, I'm told, by the middle of September. So we miscalculated again. It's just crazy. But it helps support and fund the operation, so thank you, and it's excellent. InfoWarsLife.com. X2 will sell out today. It will sell out today. Supermail is sold out.
For us not to be able to resolve that issue has been something that is distressing, but it is not something that I intend to stop working on in the remaining 18 months.
And then the chilling look that he is coming after our guns, that murderous shark-eyed glare to dominate and break America and finally get those bitter clingers. Your kids belong to the government and the globalist, your bank accounts, your guns, your Bibles. It's all being conquered right now. It's really happening. The borders are open. The laws are suspended. The illegals are allowed to fly without IDs, but citizens have the book thrown at them. Illegal aliens can just ship in 10 packages full of drugs right in front of the Border Patrol. Border Patrol literally looks the other way with their cars and drives off as the drug delivery's made. Biggs is a smart guy, and so is Owens. They say clearly the Border Patrol was given a tip to leave. Very shameful. But then lemonade stands all over the country get ticketed, fined, or arrested. Amish are under assault because humans engaging in normal commerce is illegal. The globalists want us shut down in a giant reservation slash plantation. The model is a giant cashless concentration camp. And that's not rhetoric. That's what the New World Order is. And they just put in a so-called black president to make it politically correct. Now they're going to put a woman in to do whatever she says because she's a woman. And that moves me to this next story. I mentioned this a few days ago. Didn't show the articles, and we got emails and comments going. The crazy Alex Jones claims that, you know, they say women should show their feminist and have colored arm hair and that women are peeing standing up. And people are acting like I'm obsessed with this. No, I was pointing out, while all hell's breaking loose, we're having this forced on us. Daily Mail, New York Times, Yahoo, here it is. Women who dye their armpit hair. And it goes on to show that they're feminist, they do this. A new article came out yesterday that say men cooking is an act of dominance. So now a traditional role like barbecuing, well, that's bad too. It's just see, everything's bad. You just submit to whatever they say and then maybe you'll be okay. I mean, I don't care if you want to have armpit hair. I don't have to associate with you. You know, I shave my face because I like having less hair. I think it's attractive when women shave their legs. If you're into Loch Ness Monster type stuff, that's your business. If you're into dating Bigfoot, that knock yourself. I mean, some people are into gorillas. The point is that you can do that all day long if you want. I don't have to adopt your culture. Tolerance means you can have green arm hair. You think, but again, they don't have science, they don't have jobs, their college degrees are worthless. So the media says, be special, attain something, have green arm hair, have blue arm hair. I know some guys didn't take a lot of showers, already had green arm hair without the color. Now continue in the football locker room. And then we've got this, Yahoo, learning to pee standing up to show your feminism, one woman's journey. And it's a big feminist thing. They have these little cups that look like a funnel, and you do it. And it's the new thing to do. And it's discriminatory. I scroll down so we can show folks the funnel on TV. It's discriminatory if you don't have urinals in the women's bathrooms. And again, brown paper bags are racist. I mean, you can't make this up. And don't blame all Muslims for Chattanooga, but do blame all conservatives for the theater shooting. Paul Joseph Watson article, Infowars.com. Do you understand the articles we write and the information we cover and the videos we put out are something the establishment would love to shut down? It's coffin nails to them. You understand? It's a war. We're in a savage, toe-to-toe war. And guess what? We've got some good blows in with the truth, fighting with two daggers in our hands. And globalists are stumbling around bleeding all over the place right now. The problem is they're about to counter-offense. I can tell you right now. You got to get in there, and we got to deal with them politically. We got to sever their head politically and expose them for the murdering, ghoulish, organized crime, narcotics trafficking, child molesting, absolute scum of the earth, garbage, filth, these maggot-infested... We are in the hands of extremely wicked, vicious, slathering, foaming-at-the-mouth criminals who lust... I mean, I lust after cheese and beef enchiladas covered with onions and Spanish rice and a Dos Equis lager. I lust to be at the Caribbean drinking a pina colada and smoking a big old Cuban cigar, watching my kids playing the surf. Probably not good things. They're decadent, worldly things, but that's what I'm into. You know, that's my sins. My sins maybe every once in a while sleeping an hour late. Or, you know, looking at a woman when they walk by, they're attractive when I shouldn't. The globalists, though, they desire to dominate you and fly over just villages of poor people living in shacks while they set up in big giant palaces. They lust after burning cities in wars. Hitler, it was reported by the Germans themselves, would go out to the front in the first few years of the war when he was winning it. The Polish front, the French front, the Russian front. And he'd watch through telescopes. There's film footage of this through big binocular-style telescopes. The Stuka bombers bombing things. And it said that his doctors would give him amphetamines, and he would sit there and eat maybe 20 pastries. He was a vegetarian, but he would eat, like, you know, sometimes 20 pastries. And he would just sit there eating sugar pastries in heaven in his gray uniform with guys in black uniforms around him watching cities burn. See, I wouldn't want to watch a city burn. I wouldn't get off on that. But Adolf Hitler did. I wouldn't get off on Ted Bundy, you know, for a month torturing a young woman to death. Or Jeffrey Dahmer for a week torturing somebody to death. But see, there are people that do. And when you look at Planned Parenthood and all these globalists and Michelle Obama and Hillary Clinton and all these people, and Michael Moore with six armed bodyguards, but he wants your guns, they are pus-filled creatures that know they're preying on you and have a will to follow a script and follow the power elite to be given power, even though they're untalented, stupid, bloated, weak people. It's giant armies of weak satanic scum gathering together with their desire to pull down the good. Because in their ugliness, in their diseased minds, beauty and strength and honor is like a dog whistle to a dog's ears. It's like fingernails on a chalkboard, and they want to silence it. They want to shut it down. Do cockroaches like the light coming on? No, they don't. Now, there is a Rodney James Dio line, I forget from which song, where he talks about the way that black is pretty to the purest heart. They're places of pleasure. They offer you treasure if you fly. But then there goes the soul of you and I. I know the song, it's Evil Eyes. And that says it all. Black, and I don't mean the color black, but the darkness of tyranny. It's more a blue, a cold. The way that black is pretty to the purest heart. That's absolutely true. Evil from afar, because it's so alien, and when you don't know what it is, when you haven't stuck your arm in it and found out it's a meat grinder, found out it's another dimension, looks pretty on the surface. Looks alluring. The beautiful woman who has that evil sparkle in her eye, that Jezebel spirit, seems to be more beautiful than the sweet little maiden who physically is even more attractive. Why do good men choose evil? That's another question. Because we don't just face the garden variety low-level creatures like Gollum. We face people like Obama. I am your host, Alex Jones. We're here live Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. That's 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern. We return weeknights, 7 o'clock Central, with InfoWars and Nightly News. And we'll be back this Sunday, Lord willing, with all the changes in the world, who knows, 4 to 6 p.m. Central with a Sunday live broadcast. I am going to be starting later next week in Europe, reporting on the accelerating collapse that is in the streets, that is being reported some, but also being covered up to a certain degree. But we're going to be covering what's happening in Greece, what's covering in Italy, Spain, you name it, starting in the middle of next week, right through into the next week. David Knott will be co-hosting. I'll be live on the road, also doing tape reports, also filing other special reports. So look for a lot of hardcore coverage with myself on the ground, with Rob Dew, who's going with me, in Europe starting next Tuesday. David Knight, again, will be riding shotgun here at the InfoWars News Center. Our guest is going to be with us for this hour. We'll be back next week for another full hour plus to flesh more of this out. That's why there's just so much news. Steve Quayle of stevequayle.com and the Q-Files joins us. Best-selling author, syndicated radio host for 23 years, probably one of the most popular guests, maybe even more popular than myself, on Coast to Coast AM, that I know because I've talked to the insiders, not just at Coast to Coast, but at Clear Channel, talk about how much the ratings go up when Steve Quayle is on. I would hear this guy talk about issues 20 years ago, and I thought, he's sincere. A lot of that's true, but he's crazy on a bunch of this other stuff. And then now, most of what he talked about 20 years ago, he'd been around a few years before me, that is vocally, ended up being true. I mean, I remember him talking about they've already got clones in laboratories. They're already splicing us with animals. And then, you know, 10 years later, it was mainstream news. Growing humanoids in cows to harvest their organs and saying they have no rights because the, you know, they're part pig or part cow. I mean, that's in the literature 20 years ago. Now it's in the news and it's like, oh, big deal. And oh, there's super genes they're finding in people, and they're taking your blood at the doctor and not telling you it's being sold to be tested. And then later it's worth billions and you don't get paid. I heard Quayle talk about that 20 years ago. Now it was in Wired magazine yesterday. CBS News 2 days ago. So we're living in the future. It's just not evenly distributed. There is a breakaway civilization. What we've been told about the Earth and its history has nothing to do with reality. What modern churches preach about the age of the Earth and all this is a false debate to then be discredited by science itself putting out this info. The truth is we don't know. But it's twisted interpretations of the Bible. If you actually interpret it correctly and look at what's currently happening, then it makes incredible sense, and it's scary because you go, oh my God, this is real. But you will not hear it from 99% of the preachers, folks. So Steve Quayle joins us. He's going to get into some of the wilder stuff next week in an hour and a half interview with David Knight here on this transmission. But the issues we're going to get into now is the war on the military. Bobby Jindal calls for arming the public. And then suddenly there's a shooting. They're hyping up like it's the end of the world. We're going to look at admitted subliminals and carrier waves and how screen time is brain damaging the public. That's the main issue he wants to get into. And then when you actually research what he's saying, it's in the research papers. It's even in the news that screen time is brain damaging children and adults. Don't give babies screen time. Carrier waves, reprogramming brain. Who would have known? It puts you into a sleep level. The exact carrier waves by accident, they're claiming. Because see, outside researchers at universities who weren't paid to do it by DARPA 30 years ago, they'll go and do a study and go, it's funny, it puts you in a sleep state right at near sleep, like sleepwalking, and it's an exact carrier wave resonance with the light flicker, and there's a carrier wave audio. It's really weird that they, out of thousands of different frequency levels, this right one got chosen. Because it's on purpose. I was allowed into DARPA research facilities. See, they arrest so many people now. I talked about this a decade ago, really 14 years ago, and didn't realize what I was being allowed into because it was never really spoken. It'd be like, let me take you in this lab now. And they'd be like, look on the door. And it would say, restricted DARPA. And it was at UT, and I was taken through all this stuff, and it was like a science fiction movie, and it was all about carrier waves, mesmerizing. They had a whole area about how to make women become sexually excited with electrodes hooked to their genitals to actually see. I'm not going to say it on air, but you know when a woman gets excited. And I just, even 14 years ago, when was it? It was with Kevin Booth in 99. So it was 16 years ago. I know I'm ranting. I'm going to go to Steve Quayle now. It's just he tells me his topics he wants to cover, and then I independently know it's true, and I'm just realizing this is so insane. No wonder most of the public can't wake up. They're under positronic attack. We're living in a science fiction movie. We're living in a dystopia. Why are some of us immune, or at least quasi-immune? Because when I watch mainstream TV now, I find myself wanting to just give in to it. But then something in me says, no, I'm not going to submit. But, I mean, it is powerful, folks. I guess the Bible says if it wasn't for Christ coming, even the elect would be deceived and given over to great delusion. Steve Quayle, thank you for joining us. SteveQuayle.com.
Well, Alex, what an intro. And this is probably the most pressing issue of our day because, you know, you and I used to talk at large about televisions and all the stuff they were doing with televisions. People poo-pooed it. And now I want to coin a new term on your radio program. Let's call it, instead of conspiracy theorists, let's call it conspiracy realists. The weight of evidence is upon us. And I like what, and this is important, I like what Donald Trump told
Anderson Cooper of the Central Intelligence Agency.
Yeah, nobody trusts you. 70% of the people don't trust you. And to watch the liberal left and the globalists and elitists basically crawling out of their skin over Trump. You know what's interesting? Right now, telling the truth is absolutely contraindicated in this country. Nobody tells the truth. And so all of a sudden, Donald Trump comes along and tells the truth. And boy, the fangs and the their toenails grow out into claws. But I think the thing that we got to talk about is reality avoidance syndrome. That's another term that I like to use. Look, Alex, they've bastardized the English language so bad anymore that you can't even use terms. They used to have a common meaning because everything's being twisted.
George Orwell said that was the Fabian socialist plan in his nonfiction books, and that's why he turned against them at the end, was to remove language and turn people into politically correct creatures that only knew a few dozen terms.
Absolutely. And again, Atlas Shrugged, Ayn Rand just nails it. She just nailed it. Obviously, she was involved with one of the Illuminists and knew their plans. But here's the deal. Even our television sets are not only watching us, but what you said in the introduction is so true. Infrasonic subliminal messages. If people understood that at one point in probably a decade, the majority of money in black ops was going to mind control. Now, every day we hear about neural implants. Every day we hear about basically the robots taking over. Every day we hear about cyber sex. We hear about virtual sex. What they're trying to do is divorce everyone. And I believe that video games, now look, I'm not mad at gamers, but I don't play them. But the point is,
it is a mind control platform developed by DARPA that's declassified.
Absolutely. So what we have to do is basically get people to do an amazing thing. Shut down for at least 6 hours a day. And I mean, some people are on, I can just tell you by their emailing to me, are on almost 24/7, and then they crash and come back. But the subliminal messages, and then when you basically tie it in with all the mind control, all the psychotropic drugs, and now the big announcement with scopolamine or Burundinga. By the way, Burundinga, the scopolamine dust, is called zombie dust. I remember talking about that 20 years ago, and the glaze came over everybody's eyes. But the problem is that people now cannot think. I think it was Hitler said, it's a good thing for us, people don't think. I paraphrased it. Now look at, too, all of the news that Hitler never died in the bunker with Eva Braun. Never did. Even the DNA test, independent DNA. Now, why is that critical? Because you and I have used the term the Fourth Reich, the Fifth Reich, and the Final Reich. There are people that have written books by those titles. But one of the fascinating things is that so much effort was being put in, even in the days of Germany, to control what people thought, to control, what people did. And let me give you a good example. The vilifications of the veterans, because we got to get into this. It just came out, the warnings you've been giving, the warnings I've been giving, that 238,000, I bet you it's closer to 250,000 to 300,000, of vets have been intentionally denied not only their benefits, but medical care. And this is one of the most infuriating things in the world. Yet, most of the congressmen and all of the Senate, especially the traitors in the Senate, which is the majority, do not even take up the cause, even former veterans. And when Trump made the statement about McCain that he did, in the past, we did shows on the POWs, the MIAs left behind, and his name always popped up on top of the cover-up. Now, why is this critical? Because at all costs, the globalists, the Illuminists, do not want any truth coming out. That's why the virtual reality, that's why the virtual world, that's by the consistent repeating of lies on the mainstream news. All the networks are owned by the same people. You can switch channels and get the same headline news and the same word for word. They may put on a different blonde or a different brunette, but the bottom line is it's the same message over and over. Tell a lie, tell a big enough lie, tell it often enough, and the people will accept it as reality.
And now they're intensifying the lies to a level never before seen in an attempt to overturn reality itself. I mean, we would think that this would backfire on them, but they obviously think it's going to be successful, saying 2 + 2 = 5. They actually teach that. That you can keep your doctor when you can't, that raising debt limits don't raise debt limits, that white people kill more black people than black people kill white people. I mean, just absolute inverted reality, just intensifying. And as you mentioned, just in the last couple of years, RT reported 230,000+ U.S. troops denied care, period. Every veteran I know is being denied health care at the VA right now. unless they were high-level officers. They are being told, no, we're not going to give you treatment for that. No, we're not going to take care of you. And we see in the movies now, the bad guys are the former vets. They're clearly getting ready for a purge of the military, a purge of vets, because they're worried about anybody who would know how to organize and resist during a totalitarian takeover.
Including biker gangs in Waco. One of the things that I think most people have got to understand is Fast and Furious was a big deal. It wasn't a minor infraction of the law. It was arming gangs, and what they admit to arming is totally different. 15 years ago, Alex, if you remember, there were ships being unloaded in the ports, the West Coast ports from Seattle.
It was in the LA Times they caught containers full of tens of thousands of fully auto AK-47s.
Absolutely. But what they didn't talk about was the heavy weapons that were already brought into this country in pre-staged. Good example. A friend of mine was and this is a contemporary story, a couple of years ago, and he said he was on the Columbia River in a certain town. I forget the name of the town, but he had to do an electrical check. He was a power or lineman, and he said he got into a warehouse, and his curiosity was just provoked. And he said this, there were literally hundreds and hundreds of crates of Russian weapons. Now, why is that critical? Well, the Columbia River comes right in pretty much to, parts of Washington and other parts, and they can come in on boats. They can come in on little mini subs, certain areas, depending on high tide and stuff. But this is real evidence. Now,
I remember you 15 years ago saying they were secretly training Russians in anti-terrorism for the American people in Denver. And then 2 years ago, it was on Fox News, the Denver Post, and other papers. They admitted Russian troops were here training to take on. So how are we at war with Russia, but then at the same time, under the UN, they're training them to occupy us? How does that dialectic work? And then I talked to folks in the state police, and Joe Biggs talked to folks in the Bandidos. They said that they're getting rid of the older motorcycle gangs that aren't part of the Mexican mafia in the future for a takeover in Texas. I don't know your view on that, but you mentioned motorcycle gangs.
Well, yeah, my view is that obviously the cohesiveness of a motorcycle, let's call it two, a club, okay? Because not all these guys are gangs, okay? No matter what colors. Now, you know as well as I do that whole thing in Waco was a setup. And I'm telling you this.
Even NPR now admits it was a setup.
Yep. And the shots fired. The greatest travesty, and I pray that some of the judges in Texas at the state level, including the Supreme Court of Texas, will absolutely step into this. Because those guys were held how long, Alex? Some of them 30 days?
They were grabbing people and the mom and pops in the town that weren't even part of it.
Absolutely. So, ladies and gentlemen, you've got to ask yourself why. Well, here's the answer to your question first on the gangs, because they can form, especially the veterans. I would guess, now, I don't know the makeup of those different groups that were involved, but I would guess pretty close to a majority were veterans. I would guess that. So once it's not a difficult job.
So they're just worried about any organization, just like militias, just like they don't want outside farmers markets or lemonade stands, any swap meets, garage sales. The feds passed a law for $15 million fines on garage sales. That's Fox News headline. I'm not joking. If they find one thing that's been recalled ever. So yes, it shut down any public gatherings, basically.
Absolutely. And this is why there's such monitoring. This is why there's such. Isn't it amazing? They know everything you and I type. They know everything we speak about, obviously, on the radio. They know all this stuff, yet they can't find ahead of time some guy who's texting in the opening and giving his, Arabic statements. I mean, or let's look at something even more real. It is fascinating to me that if any state is hated by the current administration, it's Texas. You remember the story? You know, you remember seeing the images when Perry was governor of Obama meeting with him, putting his feet up on the desk. Well, showing someone the bottom here is a cultural flipping off of the person in total contempt. That's their religion.
In the Middle East, yeah, Obama has those characteristics.
And the situation that is fascinating is that, you know, the Army just in the last, 24, 48 hours, basically said anybody defending you should be treated as terrorists, and yet they denied their recruiters the ability to even arm themselves with sidearms and said, pull down the blind.
Well, we confirmed it from callers, and we went out and talked to the recruiters. It's come down, and then later it was in the news confirming our report. The higher-ups of the Marines, the Army, you name it, called it, and they said, you don't even give them a chance. You call the cops and say you want them arrested for trespassing. You don't even tell them to go. We want to get these patriots in jail because this is the enemy. This is the type of American that would stand up to defend people. This is the scum. This is who we have to go after because the top brass are men and women that work for the globalist and who want to arm ISIS.
Absolutely. Now people have got to understand, when we were reporting years ago, and you started with the MAAC report and on the other documents, identifying veterans as enemies of the state.
Number one enemy. Number one. And said that veterans would attack every police department. I mean, what an insane statement.
Yep. And so the interesting thing is that in the years that I was on talk radio, said it 20 years ago, now it's important to put this into perspective because that's how long it's been building. I said the goal of the overthrow of the United States, you'll know you're in the last stages when the police have turned against the people and the people are turning against the police. And all of this has been race baiting, and it's not the white guys, and I'm not blaming blacks, but it's the Department of Justice. It's the media that foments the revolution.
You said on my show 20 years ago, in 1995, I've been interviewing you from the beginning, you said they're going to demonize the military, they're going to have a night of the long knives. When they try to turn the public against the police and vice versa for destabilization, you know it's coming. And then once they have the first layer takeover, then they're going to round up the veterans and they're going to round up the patriots in the military, and they've got a red and blue list. And now that's all admitted 2 years ago. The Army admits internment camps, and they even use the word re-education camp. Why would they use the famous Soviet term of a torture camp, a re-education? Why do they even use the same names? I mean, it's so naked.
It is naked, and the obvious point in all this is that somebody beyond the Russians and someone beyond the U.S. government is controlling the strings. The real puppet masters of the world aren't the guys, even the dynastic families of, the Rockefellers, Rothschilds, and all the typical culprits. There are even people, or as I suggest, entities that have orchestrated this. When you look at the completeness of the plan for the destruction of the United States, you know, Michael Savage said border language culture. Well, he has to add the people, too, now to that. Great Wall penetrating the weather underground. You know, Alex, again, given the amount of people that were available and alive, just the population of the United States, now they're up to about 100 million on their different lists. And these camps aren't built just to take up space. Walmarts aren't closed just to basically frustrate shoppers. There is an integrated plan underway, and this is what people have got to say. It's the bigger picture. It's bigger than martial law. It's the complete overthrow. Look at what they've done to the Confederate flag, okay? You know what flag is next? The U.S. flag. You mark my words. The U.S. flag will be considered the absolute, I would say, the symbol of racism, symbol of everything that the United States has done
wrong. We joked about it 2 weeks ago. It's now being proposed by mainstream groups to replace it with a rainbow.
Absolutely. You know? Absolutely. And so we are at the point where obviously everything that is being done is, how do I say this? We are in a position now where everyone who used to love this country, look at all of the NFL, even National Football League, everybody's down on guns and the whole situation. Your and my disfavorite person goes on Piers Morgan and starts blaming Bobby Jindal for, you know.
Stay there. Let's come back and get into that. The end game is clearly here, the beginning of the end game. We're fighting to hold it back. Can we do it? Stay with us. Well, he's produced a new documentary film and is producing a TV series. It actually starts next week. First installment is going to be on DVD, stevequell.com. True Legends, Technologies of the Fallen Ones. Pretty powerful stuff from what I've seen so far. I've got to roll some of that trailer in the background. See the trailer, read about it, and the accompanying book of a similar title at stevequayle.com. I'll get him at the end of the interview to give us more details on that subject. Steve Quayle is our guest. We know this. Bohemian Grove is going on right now. Its final day is this Sunday, and they are doing occultic rituals, having orgies, having homosexual sex. And the issue is it's the Republican leadership doing it. Not everybody that goes there is bad. Not everybody, you know, there is a Satanist. But it's a way to induct ruling class people as the doorway into the deeper cult. But even John Ronson, who snuck in with me but made me promise, the guy that wrote the book, Ministeric Goats, that got made into a movie, he wrote them. He made me promise not to say he was there because of liability. He could have gotten sued. He, I, and Mike Hansen snuck in. I had to not put a lot of the footage in to my film because it was John Ronson there with us. But I put Dark Secrets Inside Bohemian Grove out, and he was there. He saw it with me. He saw the big photo on a tree of Henry Kissinger. It was Secret Service nearby, so I couldn't get the camera hidden and get footage of it. Dressed in drag, doing something sexual. And the point is, this is not some moral judgment of this. Not because I don't make moral judgments, but because get past that and just look at it for what it is. Blackmail. Even Spy Magazine, even People Magazine admits huge problems with HIV at the Bohemian Grove back to the 70s, back to the early 80s. Just huge, bizarre behavior with former presidents, prime ministers, British royalty, Dutch royalty, female prostitutes down the road at the hotels, 2,700 acres with just men having sex with each other. This is to compromise people. And it's going on right now. Same thing at Skull and Bones. Homoerotic. Worshipping the devil. And every culture that goes downhill ends up worshipping a dark entity. So whether you believe it's real or not, the elites do believe in the devil. I've been there inside for 5 hours. And I thought it was like a stupid devil worship play. Except the men were raptured. They were dead serious, more focused than I've seen people in any holy roller church that I've attended. And I've been in Baptist, Southern Baptist, Pentecostal, you know, growing up the whole nine yards. I mean, these people were hardcore serious, and their eyes were on fire during the mock human sacrifice of a child. And we say mock because it appeared to be mock. People say, you're covering up. Look, they found dead kids in the area. There's been a lot of weird stuff. You talk to the locals, it's like one of those vampire movies from the 60s with Peter Cushing. And, you know, he's trying to talk to locals. They won't talk to him. I mean, it's like that. It's very Transylvanian looking, too. And I don't mean to digress. It's just that Steve Quayle gets off into what they're into as well in his books, in his films at stevequayle.com. Just amazing information there. Economic information, you name it. Just a great one-stop shop for everything out of this world that's connected to reality. You can get my film, Dark Secrets Inside Bohemian Grove, and then it has the addendum film, The Order of Death, a two-DVD set for $19.95 to have it as part of your library. But it's also free online. It has a 5-star rating through major third-party services where people have rated it. Hundreds of people have rated it 5 stars, both films. So if you want to support us, get the film at InfoWarsStore.com. Free shipping throughout the month of July. That ends in just 6 days. It is your purchase of the products that allows us to send reporters to Bilderberg in Austria. It's going to allow me to go to investigate how bad Europe and the collapse really is. This is important. I need to go put eyes on this because they say Rome is, quote, collapsing, London Telegraph. They say areas of Spain, 50% unemployment, collapsing. The city of London's running the whole operation. We're going to be documenting that. The Greece situation. So I'm not going to say exactly where I'll be and when, but look for that in the next 2 weeks, starting middle of next week. But before we go any further, speaking of free shipping, we came out with, I wanted to have the ultimate cleanser that has Shilajit and a bunch of other compounds. Just the Shilajit alone has hundreds of different herbs. It's like the built-up oil of herbs over thousands of years and then bleeds out of the rocks during the summer in the Himalayas. Very hard to get. Organic Shilajit, a bunch of other powerful compounds, zeolites, organic milk thistle, orange peel, cilantro, turmeric, organic lavage root. There's a whole bunch of other stuff. Fulvic and humic acid to help activate it all, and it helps support the broadcast. Now, we have this phenomenon when something first comes out, it's a bestseller. Sometimes it's not, but usually it is. So this time I said, I want to order double on our first run, because that way we'll have this for a few months. And I kind of sat around and planned it out where the next shipment is being produced right now. It's been sourced. It's being produced to be here by middle of September. Well, it'll be sold out by Monday at current sales projections. So thank you for your support. That helps fund the operation. But it still doesn't fund it long term, because it was budgeted out to fund this part of our operation until September. But then it's all sold out. So it does the same thing as if it's sold out by September when you miscalculate. That's how supply side stuff is. But thank you for your support. Deep Cleanse is available if you want it. At current sales rates, we've now sold out half of it. It was 45% sold out this morning. Deep Cleanse, body cleansing formula. The liver detox, liver shield should be back in the next few weeks. Super Male Vitality is sold out. It should be back in within a month. X2 will sell out today. I thought it would sell out by Monday, but it sold a little bit slower. But the Nation Iodine X2 proprietary will sell out today. InfoWarsLife.com. We have the great formula with the saw palmetto and the other key things that are known to help the prostate and other glands. That's available. Prostaguard, Knockout, the ultimate sleep formula, all natural with 10 different ingredients, not just one or two, known to fuse together and give you deep, restful, regenerative sleep. Nothing better than sleep for the body. That's the best medicine. Knockout is available, again, for a limited time. We did a very limited run of that, not knowing it would be a good seller. It's been an extremely good seller. It'll be sold out by next week. InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. We have 10% off all of the T-shirts at InfoWarsStore.com. And we have free shipping, as I said, 25% off the Molon Labe belt buckles. I think there's only one of those in stock now. The others have sold out. So a lot of things available. And that's how we fund one of the only true independent media outlets that's not sponsor-based. We fund about 20-30% off sponsors now. The rest is PrisonPlanet.tv memberships, ball caps, T-shirts, DVDs, shortwave radios, high-quality water filters, and the nutraceuticals at InfoWarsLife.com. Find the great line of longevity products discounted upwards of 30% off when you sign up to be a distributor for $10 at InfoWarsHealth.com or InfoWarsTeam.com. Okay, Steve, I want to get into the news with you, and then I want to talk about your updated book and your new film coming out before you leave us. And you'll be back next week to get more into the mindset of the Illuminist and why they're building this, why they're doing this, why they're trying to block off alternative histories that we continue to discover actually do have roots in reality. But Steve Quayle, giving you the floor now, because I've been ranting some here. You wanted to get into this latest shooting and how they're hyping it. Bobby Jindal, where you see the election going. Obama says he's going to go after the guns. He told BBC yesterday, in the next 18 months, they're going after Social Security recipients' guns, saying if you take a wire transfer or automatic transfer of your check, that means that you are incompetent. I mean, that's in the FBI memo. This is really bold. Are they trying to start a civil war, Steve Quayle?
Absolutely. Now, why is it critical that people understand this? The idea of the war and the primary Jade Helm states, okay, and we know it's bigger than that, Alex. I can talk about Montana and what's going on up here. But more importantly than that, they have to divide the nation. Jesus said a house divided against itself cannot stand. And so we've got, how do I say this, the 23rd mass shooting since Obama became president. And isn't it interesting, it had to be in Bobby Jindal's state, you know, Louisiana, and it's fascinating to me that the governors that care for the men in both the military or the National Guard in their states are now being vindicated. Just wait, there'll be more attacks on the states, and people are getting, how do I say this? We are at a hair trigger, in my opinion. Now, let's get back to something, because you asked me a question that's really critical. The United Nations, obviously Russia and China, are the leading ranking members by power, at least, of the Security Council. the secret agreements that exist that most people don't know, but you have been told, I have been told, we have been told, pretty much are, and this is what you've got to understand, ladies and gentlemen, they do not want you as United States citizens, they want you as citizens of the world. In order to do that, they have to take the guns. Jon Stewart was on TV with Obama, you know, saying, you got to take the guns away. And then, you know, being accused of white privilege. Well, here's the deal. In order for the communists, in order for the globalists, and by the way, communism is just one of the things that the globalists use, they want the complete. Now, Alex, here's the reality avoidance thing that I can't seem to break through. God help you to break through it. God help me and anybody else. Is that this really is the plan. We can quote the globalists. We can quote the Illuminati until we're blue in the face about they want this many people dead. How is it that the disconnect does not transfer through to people? Well, that's because, again, of the subcarrier signals, infrasonics, blah, blah, blah. But the point that's really critical is that I would think most people who, at least one in three, if they have their way, it's 9 out of 10, who are in the sights would see the bigger picture. You know, I've been told that, I don't know if you know for a fact that you're banned on military bases, but, you know, I've been told that I am banned just about on anything to do with the military, okay?
InfoWars is banned on almost all military bases. Getting to InfoWars and Prison Planet for about a decade, yes.
Yes, and I mean, we've known that for some time, but now people are saying, hey, wait a minute. If this stuff is coming to pass that Steve and Alex, Alex and Steve are talking about, then why are they banning them? Well, I'll tell you why, and this has got to sink in, because first, you know, the very first statement that the president made was he wanted a private security, basically army, and why is it that those guys, DHS, are getting funded? And while the military basically has to beg. Now, it's obvious with all of the firings of our generals, admirals, you know, senior military officials, that there's a different Pentagon now. And the Pentagon, unfortunately, I believe, is under the spell of the pentagram. And so when we talk about the war on the vets, it can be, it's not prophecy to say, here's where it's going to head to next. You just said, and this is a plan, and beyond anybody on Social Security that takes their check, they're going to consider anybody incapacitated. They're going to have, you mark my words, they're going to declare senility, or they're going to come up with something and say, every veteran suffers from post-traumatic stress disorder. They're going to...
That's right. Just like the Jews and others got persecuted in Germany, they're now getting it ready openly to say veterans, conservatives, libertarians, white people are inherently evil and now need to be dealt with unless you're a leftist. You can see the takeover. Everything the weathermen openly talked about in front of the FBI that came out in court, this was their plan. And since you raise it, think about Obama saying, I will go after the guns. I will get the guns in the next 18 months. We played that last hour. Jon Stewart says, act quickly. Take those guns, Mr. President. I mean, this is an outrageous move with them cheerleading to start the Civil War when Jon Stewart openly has armed bodyguards. I mean, these people will be held accountable when all this kicks off for their sedition against our country. So since you mentioned it, here's the Jon Stewart clip, and then I have huge breaking news. Here it is.
What are you going to do? You know, you are running out of time. It is, you know,
I'm
to some
running.
Extent.
Can I be clear about that?
Office. Definitely okay, running for office. Sure. But you don't have that much time to take away Americans' guns, declare martial law, and put hardworking Americans in FEMA camps. If you're going to do that, You better get started. You better get started.
See, they make a big joke out of it. We just had him on the BBC saying he's got 18 months and he will act. And now they're coming after the vets. They're putting them on don't treat list. That's a death sentence right there. They've built, in fact, pull up Watson's article. Just type in, yes, internment camps are real proof. Or Army manual talks about re-education camps. Infowars.com. They're like 3 years old. It has the Army field manual, how to process our Social Security numbers, how to break our families up. It's in the Army Times. It's in, there it is. Leaked U.S. Army document outlines plan for re-education camps in America. They call them that. It's at army.mil. Okay, so it's just like they first said the Planned Parenthood videos about killing kids aren't real and selling their body parts. Now they admit it. But then they had Salon come out yesterday and say it's not real and that I'm a racist and that Margaret Sanger isn't. That's inverted reality, folks. I was brought up to hate racists. My sister's Korean adopted. But I don't have to sit here and tell you I'm not racist. The proof is I stand up for life. And I'm ranting. I apologize. Steve Quayle, stevequayle.com is with us. I've got to read this. This just came in. It just broke. They were confirming it. This is exclusive to Infowars.com. Tampa recruiting offices have been evacuated due to threat. The video is on Infowars.com. Unspecified shooting threat comes 1 week after Chattanooga shooting. All recruitment centers in Tampa have been ordered to evacuate due to threats that there will be shootings in the area. Info from recruiter, Georgia resident Jeff Hansen stated in a tweet, and we did that. We had him tweet just so he could show it was on record. FYI, we have to buy bullets. Somebody call our battalion. The threat to shoot the recruiting offices in Tampa. We are ordered to leave the office. So this happened at 11:56 our time. We've just been vetting it for the last hour. And, of course, we told you that there was an order to arrest. I'm going to skip the network break. This is so important. We told everybody that this was going on. A day before it came out that there were threats in Florida, in Tampa, and that there was an order to call the police and arrest people with guns trying to protect it. That was then mainstream news yesterday. So we have all the names, all the facts documented, exclusive to Infowars.com, red-linked up at the top of the site. We're going to get it red-linked. Report Tampa recruiting offices evacuated due to shooting threat. Let's add the word shooting to that so people understand how serious this is. We've confirmed Austin's getting threats, or a suburb of Austin. We've confirmed that Las Vegas is getting threats. This goes right into what you were talking about, the attack on the military. Steve Quayle, sorry.
Well, no, that's critical that people understand that. And I'm gonna tell people what's going to happen. You're going to see a mass exodus from the military, and you're going to see a lot of people going AWOL. Now, I'm not trying to foment anything. I'm just telling you, and even the guys in the Pentagon, the people that monitor every word you say and I say, they'd better understand something, that some of these people are tired of their best friends, their fathers, their brothers, or mothers in some cases, being murdered. I want to make this clear. The Veterans Administration is absolutely under orders to deny veterans life-saving help, unless, like you said.
And let's just say it. We know there's covert programs going on to kill veterans that were in sensitive positions by poisoning them. We know that's going on, too.
One of the saddest things, Alex, is I got an email from a wife of a veteran who absolutely has to have pain medicine. You know, he's so messed up, and please, when I say messed up, so much pain, he's begging his wife to take his life. That makes me so crazy that the gutless senators, the traitorous children from hell are smirkingly keeping their silence while the greatest attack in history. We will go down, okay? It's one thing to have a Trojan horse. It's another thing to have a Trojan government. And the thing that's amazing to everybody is the Bill of Rights, the Declaration of Independence, the Constitution, our hate crimes. You put the video up years ago of the military, training the citizens.
The federal government is a globalist Trojan horse. It is the takeover.
Absolutely.
They're waging war on the vets. They're waging war on us. It's already here. Are we undoubtedly, with the Pope announcing world government, global carbon taxes, global communism? I mean, what is the system going to do, Steve? Is everything you've talked about, everything George has talked about, George Norrie, everything I've talked about with the New World Order is coming true? Drudge is reporting on it. All these other WorldNet Daily. What is the system going to do as our credibility rises and rises?
Well, obviously, they've got to stop our access to the Internet. They've got to shut us up. They'll Breitbart whoever. And that's why I tell your listeners and my listeners, pray for Alex. Pray for me. Pray for Doug Hagman. Pray for these men that are out there and women that are really telling the truth. And what I'm seeing, too, Alex, is there are some, writers that used to be considered conservatives that are, let's just say this, they make Judas Iscariot look like a little leaguer because they are so duplicitous and so treasonous. Now, here is the deal. People have got to understand that they have to go into a full reality check. They can no longer...
That's right. We were put into this incrementally. I think about this all the time. I know what you're going to say because it's in the spirit. We have been put into it incrementally. You've got to break out of it. You don't come out of it incrementally. You've got to break out of the trance. Even if you're already awake and aware, if you're not scrambling like someone being drowned to get out of this and warning people desperately... We need hysteria. We need stuff to... That's what it's for. We need the floods coming. The dam broke. Get to high ground. We need to get that kick in the ass going. Is that what you were about to say?
Absolutely. And if anybody calls... And let me tell you, neuro-linguistic programming. If anybody calls you, me, or anybody telling the truth, and I would say empiric truth, the documents that are back us up, if they call us fear-mongers, doom porn, those words are indicative of basically trying to reinvent language to get people to dismiss the truth. Look, the whole world lies in the evil one. That's what Jesus said, okay? And that means that the truth is now... the most avoided, vilified, nullified concept, I believe, in the United States and the world. Let me finish this about the United Nations. The United Nations is going to use the Russian troops, the Chinese troops, both borders. We talked about all the weapons.
Explain how it's going to work. As they dissolve the U.S. government, they have to have one program that looks legitimate for the troops and the Congress. But as you said, they're building a parallel U.N. FEMA 7277 takeover that's actually in U.S. code and already law to then use Russians and Chinese here. Then our troops are sent over there to keep control of them. That's the U.N. Agenda 21 literal Hunger Games model. Go ahead.
Absolutely. And that's why people are seeing intermingled with all the pictures of trains, with all the highways, are seeing UN vehicles. Now, this is something that most people don't understand. Those dumbs, and I'm not talking about the Senate right now, but the deep underground military bunkers or bases have so much more to bring out. Some of these bases are huge, Alex. And so what's going to happen is it's going to, as things escalate, and here's what I'm trying to... My goal is to defuse civil war, okay? I want people to understand that.
That's right.
I want the gangs to understand that you're being set up. I want the blacks to understand, and I'm talking Black Panthers, to understand they're being set up. The racism... Listen, when someone says Margaret Sanger was not a racist, that is the dumbest-ass statement I have ever heard in the world. You know, look, don't listen to anybody. When you hear someone says, you know, that doesn't sound right. Alex said she was. Steve says she was. And go read what she is, and she was. And for the record, she wanted the annihilation of the black people. More black
people. She said, I want every black person exterminated.
Absolutely. So, Alex...
And imagine fake liberal sites say in the same article, I'm racist, the Planned Parenthood video's a hoax, and Margaret Sanger was not racist. I mean, these people are pure servants of fraud.
And of hell. Let me say this. We're in the same time period. People want to go read Jeremiah 50:51. Jeremiah was the Old Testament prophet that said, woe unto them who call evil good and good evil. How about the doctor that was, you know, trying to barter with baby parts in order to get her Lamborghini? Well, I'll tell you one thing. I hope she gets her Lamborghini because she's already on a fast track to hell. People, this should absolutely be astonishing. Veterans who have defended your freedom because you sat back and did nothing, because you sat back and said nothing, this is the enemy. And those people that have said nothing, how do I say this? Done nothing, even begun to spine up, stand up, and do something, Alex. They're complicit in their own destruction. That's the other thing I can't seemingly get across.
SteveQuayle.com is the website. Steve Quayle is our guest. I'm Alex Jones, and this is the InfoWar. I wish it wasn't true, but it turns out we were right about basically everything. Except it's worse than we thought. And it looks like we could be 2 minutes to midnight. The enemy is moving. King James Version. First John 5:19-20. We know that we are of God and that the whole world lies in the power of the evil one. And we know that the Son of God has come and has given us understanding that so we may know him who is true. So you got to be able to judge who's good and who's bad in the world. And we are in him who is true. In his son, Jesus Christ, this is the true God and eternal life. Again, and we know that the whole world lies in the power of the evil one. Undoubtedly, ladies and gentlemen, we are now in the power of the evil one. And the decision's been made, the death race has begun, the trigger's being pulled, and this is the big test. Everybody thinks you're just going to lay down and it's going to leave you alone. No, that's what the wolves go after first. And just great judgment is coming upon this country. So much evil's going on. The 3 minutes we have left, you're going to be on for an hour next week at least, breaking more of this down, stevequayle.com. Tell me about your new film coming out. Tell me about the book that accompanies it at stevequayle.com.
Well, interesting, Alex. Technology of the Fallen, delayed due to the discovery of historical documents. You can go to, your listeners can go to True Legend, the series, Legends, plural, theseries.com. We found, when Tim Alberino went to South America, this is critical, we found documents that have not been seen by anybody for 450 years talking about the supernatural nature of the sexual perversion of the giants. People that don't believe this, you know, I can't do anything about your unbelief, but even Diodorus, famous historian, kind of an author, 500 years before Jesus. Bottom line is, Alex, the subject matter of supernatural evil, and you just laid it out, the Bohemian Grove and all these people, you know, they're being promised now something. They're being promised the same lie that Eve was told in the Garden of Eden. Ye shall not surely die.
Sure, well, that's the, I mean, that's the Nephilim. I mean, look at the movie Prometheus, where it's giants as well. They're just throwing it in our face.
Well, listen, my new book, and this is really important, Genesis 6 Giants, first came out, I think, 10, 15 years ago. The whole thing has been redone. 60, 70% of it's new. But what's fascinating, True Legends, the series, it's almost like we were given a time lock into the ancient past to validate and verify. Even stories that the Incans and the Mayans and the Aztec told that was, you know, basically in their oral tradition and in their stele, is that when the giants went after each other to sodomize each other, that literally lightning came down from heaven. Now, what's a shot on that, you know, or what's the chance of that 450 years ago? How about this? Conquistadors putting their sword in the eye socket of a giant, and a conquistador's sword can be 36 to 42 inches, and barely touching the back of the skull. People say, well, that's just them making it up. It's a universal thing. So True Legends of the series, where we've got the first episode pretty much done. As a matter of fact, when I get off with you, I'm going to film my last part, and I think people's minds are going to be blown away, because when you understand who's been covering up, let me address one thing real quick. How is it that the Pope is pushing for a one-world government, he's speaking against capitalism, and yet in the same breath he's saying he believes in the devil and demons? You know why he made that statement? Guess who are going to be made out to be the devil and demons? Anybody who resists the New World Order. Again, TrueLegendsTheSeries.com. My book, Genesis 6 Giants, is available on my website, stevequayle.com. And from the response I'm getting from all over the world, people are saying, thank you. Now,
I'm going to watch it. I'm going to watch it with my children. Very interesting. Steve Quayle, thank you. We'll talk to you again next week. Steve Quayle, you bet. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. Coming up, the breaking news about the recruiting center situation, the evacuation. Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central, we're here live. Back weeknight, 7 o'clock Central. I'm your host, Alex Jones. Jim Mars, an old friend of mine, the first guy to teach a college-level course on the JFK assassination, the crime beat reporter. Back when JFK got killed for the Fort Worth Star-Telegram, he looks a lot younger than he actually is. He's my everybody's favorite historian. I don't know, man. You are a living legend. But I guess you've been involved since you were really, really young. You even went to the same nightclub that Jack Ruby would hang out in. And you've had a whole bunch of New York Times, you know, top 10 bestsellers, TV shows made out of what you've done. The movie JFK, based on your book. Worked on that with Oliver Stone. Just an amazing guy. Good friend of mine. Good to see you. You're going to be speaking at Brave New Books. Population Control is one of your most important books, and I've read most of them. How Corporate Owners Are Killing Us, Jim Mars, best-selling author of Rule by Secrecy and the Trillion Dollar Conspiracy, and he joins us to break this down. But first, I want to go to this report and get his take on it. Tampa recruiting offices evacuated due to threat. Unspecified shooting threat comes 1 week after Chattanooga shooting. Joe Biggs and Josh Owen shot the video of smugglers at 60 yards away bringing in masses of drugs basically during Trump's visit to the border. That was on Drudge and made national news last night. Now Joe is talking to the recruiting offices, got them to go on record. They've evacuated all the Tampa facilities, won't let them be armed, won't let citizens come stand out front. And now this has happened. Here's Joe Biggs' report. With the text, the tweets, all the evidence, red-linked at InfoWars.com. Here it is.
Joe Biggs here with InfoWars.com. Now, about 40 minutes ago, I got a tweet from a friend who lives in Georgia, whose son lives down in Florida and roommates with a recruiter. Now, this recruiter says that they have been ordered to evacuate all the recruiting stations in the Tampa area due to a threat. Now, I talked about this earlier in the week when I was standing guard in front of the recruiter's office in South Park Meadows in the south part of Austin. One of the recruiters from one of the departments came out and said that they were getting threats in Las Vegas and in Florida. Now it looks like they have taken it to another level with a direct threat in Tampa Bay. So these guys have evacuated, and I know this because I personally have called numerous locations in the Tampa area and gotten zero answers. The phone just rings and or goes to a voice recording. So this is happening right now. We're going to keep our eyes on it. Stay alert if you're in the Tampa area, if you have the ability to swing by one of these places and see if they are indeed open or if they are vacant. Give us a tip on the video below. I'm Joe Biggs with InfoWars.com.
Joe Biggs doing a great job of breaking news stories every day, just ferreting around. Really has a nose for investigative reporting and also tracking the internet, which I know you teach journalism as well. I tell you, mainstream media doesn't do its job anymore. That's giving rise to the new media that's almost about to supplant the old dinosaur media. And here you are with a leg in each world. Population Control, How Corporate Owners Are Killing Us, available at Amazon.com and bookstores everywhere. Mr. Mars, good to have you here with us.
Let me tell you what the greatest irony is on this gun thing, okay? Here we've got trained military people who've been trained on firearms, but they won't let them go armed to protect themselves. But the greatest irony is that you'll find in my new book, Population Control, that the United States of America, over the past couple of decades, is the arms merchant of the world. We provide 78%, according to congressional records, of all the arms sold to everybody around the world, including, of course, the ISIS and the Al-Qaeda and all the rest of them.
And half the global expenditure is just on us.
Yes. So we provide 78% of all the arms to people in the world. And then we look at Russia and China. Russia's 5%, China's 3%. So we sell more arms than Russia and China combined all around the world. And yet here in our own country, they want to take guns away from everybody.
It's amazing. Aren't you a veteran yourself?
Yes, I was in the Army during Vietnam.
What do you make of the situation where we now know they've put 200 plus thousand veterans on don't treat lists and just say go die? We've known for a year and they just keep doing it. It seems like, I thought if we exposed evil, a lot of times it would get turned around back in your day or even when I was on air 20 years ago. Now the evil comes out, the IRS persecutes people 1,000 times Nixon, literally, and don't get in trouble.
Well, hey, come on, look at it, Alex. Veterans are the most dangerous group to them because not only are veterans patriotic, but veterans have weapons and know how to use them.
Common sense. You brought it up. I don't want to bring up a story I'm in. It just shows the insanity. We can put it on screen if they have it. Yesterday, or maybe it was 2 days ago, Salon, that basically takes White House talking points and regurgitates them, came out and said that the Planned Parenthood video is a hoax. Planned Parenthood admits it's real. And that I'm basically the bad guy, that Margaret Sanger was not a racist. There it is. Conspiracy theorists have hijacked the GOP. What happens when Trump, Cruz, and Carson start following Alex Jones' lead? And goes, the Planned Parenthood hoax is a case study in how we're deceptive. They admit this.
It's not a hoax. You know, well, we're into We're into when Nostradamus, the famous 16th century seer, said that we're going to go in a time period when black is white and white is black, up is down, down is up. And believe me, that's where we are, right? Peace is war.
Well, you've actually written a book that a lot of it was about Margaret Sanger and the Nazi influence in the U.S.
Right.
And you even have some slides in there. Some of it's in this book. Tell us about Margaret Sanger, since they say she was a loving person.
Well, yeah.
And I'm the racist.
You have to go back and understand about the eugenicist movement, okay? Eugenics came up in the late 1800s, and it was basically started right here in the United States, in fact, in California, and was supported by some of the wealthiest, biggest name people in the country, the Harrimans, the Mellons, the Rockefellers, and eugenics is basically, let's have the perfect race. You know, if you had the wrong skin color or the wrong bone structure or your IQ wasn't up to their standards, by the 1930s, most every state had sterilization laws, okay? And you could be sterilized involuntarily. But what happened was, is that the Germans got hold of that and said, hey, that's pretty good, and the Nazis took power. And they carried it to its logical extreme, which is, well, we have some people like Jews and gypsies that we think might dirty the gene pool. So they just said, we'll just kill them. And we had World War II, and we had the Holocaust. And the people in the world went, wait a minute, you know, we can't just go around killing people. So today, if you'll talk to these globalists, they're all still very much eugenicist. And they will say flat out, in fact, they have it etched in stone in Georgia, at the Georgia Guidestones.
Ted Turner.
He says, we want to maintain the human population at 500 million.
That's a 90%+ reduction.
Right, which begs the question, well, wait a minute, what's supposed to happen to the other 7 billion of us? And more importantly, who's going to decide who stays and who goes? And how are they going to get rid of us? Well, the Nazis show that they'll run into trouble if they try to just shoot people and hang them and kill them. So what they're doing is they are slowly thinning the human herd through bad food, bad air, bad water, bad vaccines. Do you know the third leading cause of death in America today after heart attacks and cancer is conventional medical treatment?
I didn't know that. I want to get into your book. It's simply amazing, and it's solution-based to understand what to avoid, and is along the line that I'm focusing on, exposing the breakaway civilization is poisoning us so that they can basically just phase us out, and then they can...
And profit from it.
And profit while they do it. That's the genius of these people.
They're not dumb.
And there's kind of an argument. If we put up with it, maybe we deserve it. But I want to ask you a selfish question, because I grew up hearing how great Texas was and how we were the smartest, the toughest, the most honorable, blah, blah, blah. Lord knows a lot of bad comes out of Texas, too. But now that I've studied history, traveled the world, I do know that Texas is certainly exceptional. The military has always tried to recruit as much as it can out of Texas, saying they found in combat and operations, Texans on average, make the best soldiers. And then I notice it's Texans so much that are resisting the New World Order, but it was Texans that also killed Kennedy, who also do really nasty stuff. So dark side and light side, Texas seems to be a real crossroads, and now Texas is opposing so much of the New World Order. You're a classic Texan, go way back. You're a Texas, you know, just standard great Texas guy. What do you think about Texas before we go to break?
Well, Texas is it. I'm like you, Alex. I've traveled the world. I've been to Tibet. I've been to the Middle East. I've been to Europe. I've been to Canada. I've been all over. And there's some prettier places. There's some very picturesque places. But I've never found a place in the world that I think measures up to Texas. Texas, we've got it all, and we've got beaches, we got mountains, we got forests, we got plains, we got...
But the people, too, because if you go back to Texas history...
people, yes, and you go back to the people who broke away from Mexico, and I'm not talking about the white settlers, I'm talking about Juan Seguin and the Hispanic people that lived here, and I don't know, at least in my life growing up in Texas... everybody got along. Everything's good. And you mentioned some of the bad stuff that came, like Kennedy, okay? Let me tell you something. Some of those people involved in some of the bad stuff were not even truly Texans. One of the things that's really griped me for years is the fact that the Bush family, they say, well...
Claims they're from Texas.
Well, they're Texas oil men. No, no, no. They came from Connecticut. They're just Yankee carpetbaggers. And you're right. Texas has always had a military history that we should be proud of. I know during the late, great war between the states, it was Robert E. Lee, one of the most famous generals in the world, He said, when the going gets tough, I call on my Texans. And I, unfortunately, you know, today we've all gotten fat and soft and easy, but I think it's time to buckle down and pay attention.
Well, I mean, just look how much Texas is giving the globalist resistance.
Yeah.
And then look at how the feds are cutting off the funding, everything that comes from our money anyways.
But we're creating a gold bullion repository.
Texas just took its gold back. I'm telling you, Texas is special.
We're taking a few steps now, and we need to keep going.
All right, let's get into your book when we come back. It's good to see you. Time flies, brother.
Too much time.
You're awesome. Here we go. We're here. Jim Mars is our guest. In the next segment, I'm going to ask him what the globalist endgame is. And does he agree that he's got a weird feeling like everybody else does and that things are coming to a head? But I haven't read your book yet. I've scanned over it. It looks like a page turner. I'm going to read it on the airplane over to Spain next week. But Population Control, How Corporate Owners Are Killing Us. Jim Mars, best-selling author. This is a short segment, long segment coming up. What do you want to tackle first about the premeditated plan to kill us and make money off doing it?
Well, I think the key thing here is you've got to understand, and I use quotes from many people, and I chart their activities. We got a short segment here, so I'll just put it in a nutshell.
Take your time, so we can go to the next.
This ties into everything issue that you deal with, Alex, and all the people who follow you. This has gone beyond politics. This has gone beyond philosophy or debate. This is self-defense. These people want you dead, and they're working at it. And if you care anything about the safety and well-being of your family, your loved ones, you better read my book, you better study, you better listen to Alex, and you better find out what they're doing to you so that you can have a countermeasure.
So you've researched it deeply, and they're just open. It's like Bayer knowingly putting HIV for 10 years in hemophiliacs blood product, and then it came out, they knew it and liked it.
Well, let me quote from Prince Philip, a leading globalist, okay, the head of the Windsors over there in England. He says, if I'm reincarnated, I would like to come back as a deadly virus to help solve the overpopulation problem.
That's right.
In other words, he wants to kill us. Now,
how about he goes first?
Yeah, that's what I say. Let him take the first step. But here's the whole thing. It's all based on a phony premise. All these globalists, Bill Gates,
Warren Buffett,
Ted Turner, Warren Buffett, you listen to any of them, they'll tell you that the overriding problem in the world today is overpopulation. Too many people, okay? Now, if you live in a big city and you have to put up with the noise, the traffic, the pollution, it's pretty easy to fall into that. Yeah, there's just too many people using up all the resources. But if you look at it coolly and logically, and let's look right now today in Hong Kong, the average living space is 1,700 square feet. Hey, if you had an apartment, 1,700 square feet, that's pretty decent size. It's bigger than most of the apartments I lived in. And based on 1,700 square feet, the entire 7.5 billion population in the world could live comfortably enough just in the state of Texas.
That's true, and I've seen those statistics. But the West is dying and has a problem. We're having 1.3 children on average for two adults. You got to have 2.1 to even replace and take care of the folks, or economies collapse. We know this. The third world is growing fast. They have dirty technologies. It is causing some problems, but they're suppressing, as you know, you've written books on it, a lot of advanced technologies that would have taken us out of this.
Right. None the least of which would be to pursue and move on into space, as we heard about when we were kids.
Hey, plus, humans need a goal. Yeah.
We'll go to the moon. We're going to mine minerals. It'll pay for the space problem. We'll go have colonies on Mars, and we'll keep going.
But then you'd have to be a fan of humanity and not write us off.
That's right. And it's hard enough to control this world, much less if you go into others.
You wanted to get into glyphosate. I said, what's the most important thing in your book? And you said glyphosates.
Even the World Health Organization now has admitted that glyphosate is a carcinogenic. It can cause cancer. But what I'd like to point out is that they've showed that the rise of glyphosate use, which is the major ingredient of Roundup, which is the Monsanto herbicide, which they are putting now on all of our important food crops, soy, corn, wheat. And you can draw a parallel rise between the rise of the use of glyphosate and the rise of autism in children, which has just gone out.
You know, that's shocking. I'm no chemist, but You mean lots of weed poison, hundreds of billions of tons being used a year, 400 billion tons a year now being used in every water table? Weed killer might not be good for our brains?
Well, gee, poison?
Whoa, that's a conspiracy theory.
But now, I tell you, you want something shocking. Dr. Stephanie Sinnott, a MIT research scientist who says that there is a definite link between glyphosate and autism.
Definite link. That crap stinks, yeah.
Yeah, and she says that by 2025, that's just 10 years from now, she said at current rates, every other child will be autistic.
Well, I think that's a good, I mean, thank you, New World Order.
Yeah. Well, and from their standpoint, that's pretty good because, hey, it'd be easy.
By the way, that's only 10 years away.
I know.
And then half the new kids will be retarded.
Yep.
And they're like, oh, don't use the word retarded, but it's okay to kill them. It's okay to brain damage them, just use the politically correct term. Okay, let me be correct. They're going to be seriously mentally disabled.
Right.
Now can we talk about... But it's okay. I mean...
It's okay because they'll vote Democrat.
Oh, boy, you're something else. Jim Mars is our guest. Stay with us. Jim Mars is going to host the show. I told everybody that for about 6 years, I've been doing the show 20, it's been syndicated for 18 and a half, but for about 18 plus years, I've been on from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. And for about 5 years, 6 years, it's about 5.5 years, I did a fourth hour. But when I started doing the nightly news and getting a lot of crew members under me and have a lot of administrative stuff and research stuff, I shifted and stopped doing the fourth hour because it was just killing me. I mean, I literally had to go take a nap for like an hour afterwards. 3 hours kills me, too. I think it's the bright lights or whatever. When I do it, the show at home every once in a while, and it's dark, I just feel great and want to go forever. It is. I'm actually thinking about sometimes just doing the show from home and having anchors in here that are covering news, just because people say that sometimes when it's not even video, they say, man, the show's even better when it's just old-fashioned radio. Maybe a day a week or something, I'm going to start doing that in the future. But long story short, absolutely. Jim Mars is going to be hosting 30 minutes of the next hour by himself in here. He's a great guy, smart guy. He can do the whole fourth hour if he wants, because a lot of stations want that fourth hour. We are going to start having it be a guest host hour. I'll host it a lot of times as well. We'll have roundtable discussions. It'll be a news hour. It'll be really something special every day. That fourth hour, we're bringing it back. And some stations never turned it off when I quit doing 4 hours 2 years ago. A lot of stations still carry it. So Jim Mars will be doing as much of the fourth hour as he wants. In fact, I predict you'll want to do the whole thing, Cupcake. So that's coming up. And if you want, you can get the number out and take calls. But
yeah,
before I do that, we have to self-fund here. And I simply go out and whatever I use, what I like, what I think's neat, is what I end up trying to go out to the distributor, to the manufacturer, and get. G-Shock watches are the original tough watches, so they're the most state-of-the-art and the most updated today. Military uses them, everybody knows that. And they're also very, very affordable compared to other watches that don't even have the same tolerances. We now have a wide selection. We're adding them right now to InfoWarsStore.com of the G-Shock family. We have this distributorship through Head Down. So we're now directly drop shipping through them, and we're carrying the Vortex Viper at the lowest price you'll find anywhere, optics, and just so many others. And this thing is owned by former Special Forces, Army, Navy SEALs, armorers, laser sights, green laser sights, AIM Titans, Surefire, all the very best stuff that is at the best price. Just guaranteed no games for your assault rifle, for your handgun, for your revolver. It's all there, InfoWarsStore.com. You go over on the right-hand side, and you'll see InfoWars Life, made in 1776, health and wellness, coffee, water purification, preparedness products, seed center, books, current specials, clearance, discounts, longevity, PrisonPlanet.tv, head down products. And now at the bottom, optics. So optics, watches, all the hardware you need. That way you get a great price, and the small profit that's there, wish it was huge profit, we could fund things easier, then helps fund the reporters, the research, the work we're doing. InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com, where you can go and find all of our high-quality supplements. And there are a ton of them. The latest, of course, is the Deep Cleanse, known to cleanse out the body, Shilajit and other key compounds like zeolites, knock out an amazing sleep aid where you just put all the best, purest stuff known to knock you out, deader than a hammer. That's there. Believe me, I've taken other sleep aids that are natural. They help a little. Melatonin, valerian, I got to take them together. This, I'm going to be taking this tonight about 10 o'clock because I got to get up early tomorrow and do a bunch of stuff. And the thing is, I just keep wound up. Even if I had that coffee since like noon, I just want to stay up till 2, 3 in the morning, and then I'm exhausted when my kids get up at 6:30, 7 in the morning. Well, I can take knockout, and within an hour, man, I am sleeping deep, and I don't wake up, even if the dog or the cat's jumping on me or the kids try to come in or thunder and lightning or whatever. So InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free. We're going to answer all your questions about optics, about watches, about shortwave radios, cook stoves, water filters. It's basically I'm a guy, I don't get me near a Cabela's. Don't get me near a hardware store. I'll be in a little town, see a little gun shop or a little hunting supply shop. I'm in there. Well, this is the very best stuff, and then you're not just getting some fun stuff for your cabin or your vacation house or your garage or your truck or presents for your kids, your husband or whatever. You're funding a hardcore liberty operation while getting your rifles ready for hunting or self-defense or whatever the case is. So it's all available at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsLife.com. Okay. You have the floor and get practiced because you're going to be hosting the next hour and you'll have some breaks to get up and go to the tinkle area. But Jim Mars, my good buddy, best-selling author, is here. The new book, Population Control. And this is a book I can really get behind. You've had a lot of other amazing books, but I kind of know about JFK because I read your book 25 years ago. And you can write a book about the rise of the Nazis and how the Fourth Reich's connected to us. And I kind of know that. A lot of folks don't. This new book, I was reading through it, got a lot of stuff I didn't know, and it really puts it all together for the case. We ought to sell this ourselves. We don't yet. We sell a lot of your books and dovetail it with Endgame, because my film Endgame covers a lot of this as well, that their Endgame is take over, shut off the resources, and kill everybody. So, Jim Mars, people can go to your website and also get the book. Give them your website.
Website, oddly enough, is jimmars.com. JIMMARRS, two R's and Mars.
A good Scottish name.
Aye, correct, you are.
Can you do a Scottish accent for me?
No.
We there, the Buckins coming. I can't even do it.
Footman.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. I think I lost my Scottish accent.
You look like a Scottish guy, though.
Yeah, it's true. Speaking of, did you hear where there's a famous pub in Scotland and the managers announced they have a new policy that they're making the waiters wear pants? Because this is true.
Really?
Because too many women were coming in and trying to pull up their kilts to see what they were wearing. Mm. And they said, at first it was funny, he said.
But I hear women go after the Scotch yeah. kilt.
Yeah, that's right.
There's nothing feminine about it. I mean, it's comfortable.
Manly kilts.
Absolutely. And then I could wear a kilt and then be on TV and get a Courage Award like Caitlyn Jenner at ESPN.
That's right. Hey, you could declare because you feel like it that you're a third gender.
Wait a minute. I'm going to go to you in a minute. Can we pull up that I've announced I've come out of the closet? Can you guys pull it up? The videos, Alex Jones comes out of the closet. I've come out of the closet, but not that I'm a woman or not that I'm gay, but that not that I'm a space alien or a blood drinking lizard from the planet Pop-Tart. No, I've come out. Do we have the video ready? Yeah, we're going to pull it up. I mean, it's in the system. I know I just sprung it on you. The video's on InfoWars.com. Alex Jones has now come out of the closet. While they're finding it, what do you think this obsession with this stuff is? Is it about diverting from the fact that we're all losing our basic rights so the new right is that women can pee standing up?
I don't know. To me, it's proof of the psychological problem that they've noticed with rats. You know, you put a few rats in a cage, they get along just fine. You put too many rats in a cage, they start going nuts and they turn on each other. And I think maybe that's it. There's too many people crammed together. And
so people don't feel like they have a future. They don't feel like they can be creative. Used to, you wanted to explore. You wanted to invent. You wanted to build. You wanted to have art. Now it's, I'm going to have green arm hair. That shows that I'm mad at men. I'm going to pee standing up. I mean, I'm not joking. They have serious shows going, women are peeing standing up. This is the true feminism. And it's just like, it's just stupid.
Well, I don't care. Like Bruce Jenner.
I mean, I'm going to freak out if I walk in the men's bathroom and that's going on.
Bruce Jenner can call himself anything he wants to, but when it comes down to biologically, he's a man. And I
did you see what they said on CNN? One of the co-hosts said, "I'll put you in a hospital if you say that again."
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, yeah. There, that's tolerance. The leftists and the crazies. They practice tolerance, and if you don't want tolerance, they'll beat the crap out of you and put you in the hospital.
And you know, I would think of you as a classical liberal. You're for drug decriminalization. You're for alternative energy. I mean, the liberals, you know, really like you, but you're not a fascist. I mean, you're not wanting to arrest. I mean, it's not that we care if some guy wants to be a woman. I don't want to pay for it.
No, and I differ with you. I've never thought of myself as a liberal. I think of myself more as a conservative. But when
I meant like a classical liberal, yeah, like Thomas Jefferson.
Well, that's it. It's like, if you're conservative, what is it that you want to conserve? Too many so-called conservatives today, particularly the rhinos, you know, they want to conserve the status quo. And that's not me. What I want to conserve is the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, and the idea of freedom.
Private property, do what you want.
Private property and equality, you know. When the Civil Rights thing came around, and I stopped and thought about it, and I was a good old redneck Southern Texas boy, but I thought, you know, they got a point. Why should somebody be discriminated against because of the color of their skin? I said, I'm backing off. I'm going to help them out. Whatever, let's all just be equal. But, you know, it's not even equal anymore. Now it's reverse racism, and people just don't get it because, you know, I think everybody, if I say I'm going to vote for this person because he's black, okay, well, you know, that's just as much racism as to say I'm going to vote against
him. I would vote for a black Ron Paul and wouldn't even think what color they were.
Right.
I could literally, or a woman. But they're going to make, if we don't want Hillary, that we're against women.
Well, no. See, that same way. I have no problem at all with a woman in the White House. I just, not Hillary, because I don't think she qualifies.
Well, yeah, because she probably actually is a man in drag. She's the reverse of Jenner.
Well,
no, yeah. Actually, she is Jenner.
Generally speaking.
I'm being sarcastic. They actually say that Michelle is a tranny.
I heard that, and I snickered that one off until I really looked at it seriously. And
she's got.
I think there's some question there.
You don't think that's like a cigar she's hiding in her pants?
Well, it could be. It could be. She might just have saggy panties. I don't know. I don't want to go there. I'm still having trouble enough trying to tell people, explain the problem of two planes knocking down three buildings.
Maybe when they El Chapo Jenner, it shot off like a missile and blew up Building 7.
Yeah.
I mean, that makes as much sense. Okay, I'm going to stop right there. It's a family show. But this is what's in the news. How do you not talk about it?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, if they're just force feeding all this garbage. We do have the video. So this is my coming out. I have become a dog, bloodhound. Right. I am trans species, and if you don't agree with it, then you're a racist. Here it is.
But if you love your dog,
you know, Caitlyn Jenner is actually the real El Chapo. The problem is he hasn't actually done the chopping, so I say he's a fraud. But me, I've gone and I've had surgery, and I've had these prosthesis ears added. I am now choosing to be transzoological, I believe is the term. I may just have to be transabled and chop my arms and legs off and be known as a biscuit and live in a box. Be taken care of. And if you don't accept it, you're hateful. In fact, if you don't adopt my lifestyle and wear dirty brown socks on your ears after you work out, you're a racist, you're a homophobe, you're an anti-zoological phobe, you're a piece of filth. So now, I become my new self.
That's real. I actually, you know, I saw the latest conspiracy. I think I sent it to Nico. Because it's sad, but all these schizophrenics and mentally ill people that are now online, they have a voice, which is good. Everybody has a voice now.
Sure.
But now they don't just think I'm Bill Hicks. They think Rush Limbaugh is, wait for it, Jim Morrison. Oh, my God. I mean, that one is even better.
That was a good one, Alex. I've got a fire hydrant out there I want to introduce you to.
Oh, yeah.
You'll love it. Love it first sight.
You know, actually, since I put those ears on, I have been peeing on fire hydrants. And it's my right to do it.
That's right.
It's my right. And I deserve a courage award. There it is. Rush Limbaugh, a.k.a. Jim Morrison, was Bill Hicks, a.k.a. Alex Jones' influence to get on radio. So that's how it's all connected. I mean, look at this. And this is not satire. These people actually back it up. They actually, on this video, show side by side should say Rush Limbaugh's Jim Morrison. They're so crazy.
Yeah, I know. How silly can you be? I mean, everybody knows you're actually Karl Rove.
Oh, man. David Mendelsohn. Listen, I did this video where I said I was really a British thespian as a joke. People think it's real now. They're searching David Mendelsohn. That's the thing. They won't admit that glyphosate is connected to brain damage and that one half of the kids in the country by 2025 are going to be brain damaged. That's admitted and is epic. The government admits fluoride's brain damaging us now.
Right.
But no one will talk. They admit chemtrails are real. No one will cover the real documents. They just want to speculate. And then that's how the media tries to discredit us. You know, I'm just trying to cover up. I'm actually Jim Morrison. I'm insulted. I mean, I like Bill Hicks at some levels, but I think Jim Morrison as a musician was more interesting. So actually, I am Jim Morrison.
Well, you're being accused of it. You might as well go for it.
Oh, they're already connecting me. He says, Jim, we'll be spawns of Satan together. I guess we're talking about us.
Well, you're gonna
have Ashley, are you really Jim Morrison?
You have to do something with your hair.
All right, I'm going to stop. Start getting into your book, get into the more serious areas, and then, you know, a lot of times we go out and have beer together. That's a lot of fun.
That's right.
And we look up at 7 hours has passed.
Hey, that would be your fourth hour right there. You just move to a local pub and sit around and have a few beers and then just talk honestly.
Please don't give me that idea. We've actually had that idea, but I've pretty much quit drinking to lose weight. So, you know, I only drink after six now. And of course, it's always six somewhere on the planet.
Well, maybe
I'm being sarcastic. I'm not a heavy drinker.
If you're drinking six, maybe you ought to cut it down to two.
I mean, I'd only drink at six. I get it cut from six to two.
I have
two at two and three at three and four at four and five at five and six at six. And
well, hey, take me. I don't drink anymore or any less. Pretty much.
No, we'll go have Mexican food and have a Dos Equis or two.
There you go.
I mean, let's be honest. We're not that cool.
That's true. That's true.
Anyways, I apologize, Jim Mars. You're here with your new best-selling book.
That's right.
Tell us about it.
No, listen, I'm serious about my book because there's a lot of information in there of how you can protect your family and your loved ones because when I get my chance, I'm going to tell you about some of the really bad stuff that's going in everything, aspartame and monosodium glutamate.
And most of our audience knows this. But
they already know this.
Their families don't.
Exactly.
And this way you can go, here's a prestigious author, Jim Morrison, who's written this new book. You need to read it.
But what I'm gonna tell you is that even the good stuff is bad. The incidence of obesity in this country has shot up 85%.
Look how fat Jim Morrison got.
That's right.
He used to be really skinny. Now he weighs like 400 pounds and hosts a radio show.
I hate to sit here and talk about obesity, but no, Alex, actually, I think you've lost some weight. I really do.
Thank you.
I really do. Anyway.
Well, I am still, here's the difference. In fact, I'm just going to take my clothes off on air. Let's just do it right now.
Oh, please.
No. I'm dead serious. Don't do it.
Don't do it.
Well, no. I mean, I'll just show people how much weight I've actually lost. I've actually lost almost 70 pounds.
I believe it.
But that shows how fat I got. Now I'm like 230. I was like 280.
Well, I have all the admiration in the world for people that can actually gut it out.
I've been to the doctor and the nutritionist. I got 10 more pounds to lose.
Wow.
But thing is, I have a really big, giant, round head. So no matter what I do, it'll always look like I have a big, fat head. Jim Mars, you're going to host the entire next hour. You're going to take phone calls as well. Some stations don't carry the fourth hour, but they're welcome to. We're reintroducing it. We're going to start having guest hosts. I'll host it some. We'll have roundtable discussions. Jakari Jackson's going to host. Rob Dew's going to host. David Knight's going to host. Darren McBreen loves to do live. He's going to be hosting. We can have roundtable with the control room crew. They're really smart guys and gals. They're going to be in here. That's what it's all about. 3 hours of Pumpkinhead, and then you get the garden gnome. See, he's calling me that names. I can strike back. Anyways, he actually is a little garden gnome in the corner of my garden. That's where he lives in my backyard, Jim Mars. Now, Jim Mars is a sweetheart. Your wife's back there. I want to say hi to her. You can take a bathroom break or get some coffee or anything you need during these breaks coming up. But some stations don't carry, a lot do. Infowars.com/show to find the free video feed and audio feeds to see and hear that fourth hour. He will be serious for the first 20, 30 minutes. Please go over your book, break it down, and then take phone calls. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231 to talk to Jim Mars. Or actually, he's really Rush Limbaugh, and then the Rush Limbaugh is really Jim Morrison, and I'm really Rush Limbaugh. Or I'm the Loch Ness Monster. So 800-259-9231 is the toll-free number to join us. But you wanted to talk about some good news during the break.
Good news. Oh, yeah. Well, consciousness is rising, but it's also creating a problem because the more people wake up, the more the New World Order clamps down.
Absolutely. Explain that to people. You're saying when you started doing this 50 years ago, you've been around that long. Yeah. In fact, you may actually be the real Gandalf.
No, I'm Santa. I'm not actually that old, but it's true. When I started off, and I'd be on radio shows or whatever, and I'd try to tell people, you know, there's a clique of people trying to run the world, and they're meeting in secret societies, and they're trying to set the agenda, and they're trying to run everything. And I'd get these calls coming in saying, hey, how do you let this guy on the air? You know, this guy's a nut. You know, this guy's a conspiracy theorist. This guy's a buff. This guy's an idiot. You know what? The last 10 years or so, I don't get those calls anymore. I'm sure those people may still be out there, but they're keeping them to themselves.
Well, you know, it was declassified in congressional hearings many years ago that the CIA in the 60s started using that term. The Clintons, in their first presidential run, it's been released by their library, that they said anyone criticizing them, call them a conspiracy theorist.
Oh, exactly. No, it goes back to 1954. 1967, I believe, after the Kennedy assassination, and there was a document filed by the CIA's Division of Intelligence and went to all their bases and all their assets. And if you know anything about Mockingbird,
media,
it went to the media, and it said anybody that's questioning, anybody questions the government, you call them a conspiracy theorist. And that's why it's interesting. I have a 1940 dictionary, and you go look up conspiracy, and it says a plan. That's all it was, a plan.
Yeah, so if we ever talk about bad people having plans in government or corporations, it doesn't exist. Well, everybody knows it does.
Of course. Our legal system puts people in jail every year convicted of conspiracy.
Ladies and gentlemen, in 70 seconds, we return with the fourth hour hosted by Jim Mars. All right, folks, it's Alex Jones here in the studio, and Jim's had 70 seconds to get ready for his premiere of hosting syndicated talk radio to millions of people. But don't worry, the fourth hour probably only has about 500,000 people watching and listening, not a couple million like the main show, but not for long, because after we start hosting the fourth hour, it's going to be huge. So, Jim, without further ado, you got a short segment of 5 minutes. You'll come back with 12 minutes, come back with 6 minutes, come back with 18 minutes, and come back with 5 minutes, and we got loaded phone lines from folks all over the world wanting to talk to Jim Mars. Ladies and gentlemen, Jim Mars.
Here he is, star of stage, screen, and outer space. And he's not kidding. I mean, I came here to speak with my friend Alex, and all of a sudden, I'm it. I don't know. I guess he had to go make a bathroom run or something. But it is interesting, though, and I'm happy to be here because, especially since we can take calls, because I'm always interested to find out what people want to know about. You know, I'm always making these talks, and I watch carefully to see how many people get up and leave, and I'm gratified that very seldom do many get up and leave. So I guess they're interested in it, but I never really know what they actually want to hear about. So here we have some calls coming in, but before we start taking the calls, I want to plug for population control, how corporate owners are killing us. There's a ton of information in there, and it's information that you really need to hear about bad food, bad air, bad water. Let's talk about water for just a minute. One of the things that's being really a contentious issue today is fracking. All right, and for those of you who don't know what fracking is, that's a short term for hydraulic fracturing. And what they do is they pump water with about 40,000 chemicals in it deep into underground to under high pressure, so it'll crack the earth and open up these strata down there in the deep underground. And the idea is because so they can bring out more gas and oil. And now this comes back to a little thing known as peak oil, which I'm sure you've probably heard about if you don't understand it. And this goes back to the 50s with a professor named Hubert, who somehow determined that by the year 2000, we were going to hit the peak of oil. Okay, and that's only so much oil because there were so many dinosaurs that died and plants that fell over and got compressed under the layers of the earth for billions of years and created fossil fuels, and that there's only so much of it there. And when you get to a certain point, it's going to be gone. And he said that point was going to peak at the year 2000, and that's it. It's all over. Well, folks, that turns out to be another bogus theory, okay? In 2011, 2012, oil and gas production were at higher rates than ever before. But the key thing is this. If somebody tries to tell you, well, no, we're running out of petroleum, we're running out of oil, here's three words you throw back at them. Bakken rock formation, okay? B-A-K-K-E-N. The Bakken rock formation stretches up through Montana and the Dakotas and into Canada. And it is a vast, underground, untapped source of petroleum. And the experts have estimated that even at increased rates of consumption, there's enough petroleum there to last us for 2,000 years. Holy cow. So see, there it is. And there's no reason then to be pushing all of this fracking. Because there's plenty of oil untapped. I also might mention, those of you who know your history know that beginning of the 20th century, and I hear some music playing, so all I was going to say is early 20th century, you had the Teapot Dome scandal about oil, federal selling public oil privately, and that's still going on. We got a lot of oil. More right after these extremely excruciatingly serious messages. All right, there's some patriotic music for you. And howdy, here I am, Jim Mars, your stand-in temporary host on the Alex Jones Show today. Stuck with this last hour. I mean, pleased to have this last hour. But before we continue talking about the oil or the lack thereof, let's take a quick break for some breaking news from our InfoWars reporter, Joe Biggs. Joe?
Today, I actually got some information from a friend in Georgia. Now, his son lives in Tampa, Florida. He roommates with a recruiter at one of the local stations in that area, and he has given us information saying that they have been told to evacuate. Now, Don Salazar and myself have both called numerous recruiting stations without any answers. The phone will ring and or go to a recorded statement at that point. Now, we have confirmed, though, we actually have a listener who has gone down to the numerous recruiting centers in Tampa, has taken pictures of empty offices. So this is happening due to a threat that they got for a shooter that could possibly happen. Now, earlier in the week, I spoke to a recruiter in South Austin who said that some of the offices in Las Vegas and Florida were getting threats of another attack. Now, this comes a week after the shooting in Chattanooga that left numerous Marines and a Navy sailor dead. So we've got to take this seriously, and I want people in that area, you know, to be on watch. And if you can, if you know anybody in those areas, call them, make sure they're okay, find out what's going on, and send us some tips.
And just to add the point, good job to the citizen reporters going out there and being the eyes and the ears on the ground. This is the human intelligence of the American people and people of the world that can outmaneuver the mainstream media and the rest of them. They want to cover up what's happening at these recruiting centers and show the real terrorism threat in this country. They're obsessing still about two people dead in a movie theater as if it's the end of the world and making it a big deal while ignoring five dead. Look, all the deaths are important, whether it's people at a military facility or at a recruiting center or folks in a movie theater, but they're doing this to demonize the American people. Other points, we're going to throw it back to Jim Mars, but great job for you and the team and Adan Salazar getting these reports out, and to that citizen reporter. We're adding those photos, I'm told, right now, confirming they're empty at those facilities. So they've abandoned their post. They've been told to evacuate and run up the white flag by the traitors in charge who won't let them be armed.
And on top of that, they've already forced the Marine Corps recruiters to not wear their uniform and essentially wear civilian attire. Well, this is what we have to remember. Gun-free zones are kill zones.
That's absolutely correct. Thank you, Joe. Stay with it. Yeah, I don't understand this at all. I mean, you have military men. These are men, if there's anyone who could be trusted with a firearm, it would be a trained military man. And yet these guys are saying, oh, no, you can't take your gun and don't wear your uniform. Folks, this is, all I can think of is un-American. And also, back to our discussion, during the break here, they brought me a copy of Newsweek from 1979. And in here it says, why we must act now, because it says 1979, we only have 8.7 years left of petroleum, crude oil. That's it. We're going to be out, folks. And we've heard that for so long, and it's simply not true. There's oil everywhere. Plus, we do need to wean ourselves off of oil because we're killing ourselves on oil pollution. You know, you realize, and I'm sure Alex has brought this up, that they're still spraying Corexit down in the Gulf of Mexico, and the Gulf is almost dead. We got problems with Fukushima, and they're still admitting they can't stop that radiation leak. In fact, there is more and more evidence that the Pacific Ocean is having all kinds of problems because of this continuing radiation. And what's our good government done about it? Well, as I understand it, they no longer monitor for radiation on the West Coast. Well, how convenient. Now they don't have to tell us how badly they're radiating us. So, but back to the water situation before we go to the callers, and I am interested in getting calls. I want to explain that not only is the whole idea of fracking unnecessary because we do not need to find even more outlets for gas and oil. So there's something else going on. And what an increasing number of people believe is that this fracking is done for one major purpose, and that is to adulterate and to destroy our water tables, okay? And why would that be? Who would want to destroy our water? Well, right now today in the world, there are about a handful of major corporations who are gaining control over the water supply. We find, water is so critical now in California that Governor Jerry Brown has announced water reduction with fines, okay, that possibly can fine you up to $500 if you water your lawn. And what kills me is having been out there, I know I was visiting in Palm Springs, and we went to a golf course there, such as the one you see here. And it was beautiful. I had sprinklers, you know, spraying. And then I find out that in Palm Springs alone, there's 125 golf courses. Now, here's 125 golf courses built in the California desert, you know, and that they all have to water the greens and the fairways and then wonder why they're running out of water. It's ridiculous. But then you also find that these wealthy families are investing in water. Because, in fact, the head of Dow Chemical was quoted as saying that water is the oil of the 21st century. And you have a handful of corporations, Nestle, Coca-Cola, Perrier, who are gaining more and more control over the water. Now, you know, a person can go a few days without food and can still function. But if you don't have water, you're in real serious trouble. And so then we look and we see that this wealthy elite, they are buying into the water industries. Warren Buffett, for example, is heavily invested in water treatment and water filters. T-Bone Pickens has bought up property all up and down the Ollagaller aquifer, which provides water for the breadbasket in middle America. But the one that really caught my attention was some years ago, it was reported that the Bush family had bought something like 300,000 acres in Paraguay. All right. And knowing the background of the Bushes and the pro-Nazi stand of the patriarch Prescott Bush, who was prosecuted during World War II for being a front man, financial man for Hitler and the Nazis, I thought maybe they were going to build a housing development and call it Borman Acres or something. But come to find out, the Bush family and their 300 acres in Paraguay just happens to sit over the Guarani Aquifer, one of the largest single bodies of groundwater in the world. So they're slowly but surely trying to gain control over the world's water supply. Now think what kind of power that would give someone. You want to drink a water? You pay what I say. In fact, and I've watched that just over my own lifetime. When I was 13, I went to work in a grocery store sacking, and then before long, I'd worked my way up, and I was checking. In fact, I worked in the meat department. I worked in the produce department. I got a pretty good grocery education. And if you had come to me at that point and said, can you show me where the water is? I would have pointed you to the water fountain or to the hose outside. You turn on the faucet, and the water comes out. Nobody was buying water. You know, that was considered a natural resource, and it was belonged to everybody. But then over the course of my life, I've seen all of a sudden there's been a section of the drink shelf where you've got bottled water, and today you have an entire aisle full of water. And if they don't get you with the public water, just be sure and read some of the labels on the bottled water, because there are already some of the bottled water is being fluoridated. And that's another thing I talk about in my book, Population Control, is that in the 1930s, if you bought sodium fluoride, it came in a can and marked poison. But this is what they're giving you today. So the whole purpose of fracking, I think, is to wreck the water tables. And you need to be aware of that, and we need to start cleaning up our water supplies, and we need to start caring about what we're doing, because we're ruining one of the most basic necessities of life. Okay, where are we? We got a couple of minutes left. If you'll notice, I've been joined by the Queen Mother of England. Oh, no, I'm sorry. It's... my friend Gator. I think Alex caught him crawling around outside or something. Must be an infiltrator, but he's been pretty passive for right now. I think we got time maybe for one call. Can we get a call
sure,
in here?
Yeah, let's start with John in FEMA Region 5.
Okay, we got John in FEMA Region 5. Howdy, John.
How are you doing, Jim? It's about time I got a chance to talk to you. I've watched a lot of your videos from the Contact in the Desert series, and I go to your webpage occasionally. And I was wondering if you could explain the actual cycle of the New World Order, starting with Babylon and the King Nebuchadnezzar, and how it grows through a crescendo and then crashes and goes underground. And comes up with different eras. Because I think if people start looking at it, you can see where it's coming from and where it's going.
Okay. Well, you know, let's see now. I've got a minute or two, and you want me to give the history of the human civilization in the world. Okay. That's going to be a toughie. And in fact, I hear the music starting, so while I try to compress world history into a couple of minutes, let's go ahead and cut for the break. And when we come back, I'll trace the New World Order back to its beginning. And you're listening to your standby temporary itinerant transit host, Jim Mars, and filling in on the last hour here for Alex Jones. And we just had a caller, John, who had asked, you know, how did the New World Order start? And, we could have three or four programs talking about that. But let me point you to my book, Our Occulted History. And what you find is you go far back and even beyond our recorded history, and there are legends and stories in every ancient tribe and peoples in the world, from the Aborigines in Australia to the North American Indians to the Hindu Indians in the Vedas, to the Bible, Ezekiel and the wheel, and to the some of the oldest writings in the world from the Sumer civilization that predated the Egyptians over in Mesopotamia. And they all say the same thing, that folks came from the sky and taught them various things, language, law, mathematics, garden, farming, agriculture, and to my surprise, even taught them how to make beer. I being a somewhat of a beer aficionado, I once tried to research it and find out, well, you know, where's beer come from? Because after all, it's easy to figure out how ancient man figured out wine. You know, you got some grapes that fell off the grapevine, lay on the ground under a hot sun, fermented. The thirsty caveman came along, says, wow. He tries some of that, and he says, oh, and then he gets a buzz, and he's going, I really like that. So now he's got wine. But beer, beer? You have to have malts and hops and various things, you know, and then you have to mix them in just the right proportion, and you have to add water, and then you have to have some sugar, and then it's all got to ferment a certain amount of time. I mean, this is a complicated formula. How did somebody figure all that out? Well, according to these ancient tablets, these cuneiform tablets left by these ancient Sumerians, they're the people that came from the sky. Their gods, if you will, taught them how to make beer. And they had four different kinds of beer back in the ancient world, okay? And something tells me one of those types was probably not light beer. They probably had something else. But the point is that they all tell the story that there were these outsiders who came and set us on the course to civilization. Now, these outsiders, they didn't want to have to mix with the raggle-taggle humans, so they created kingship. They created interlopers. They created a priest caste that would pass along and deal directly with the humans. And over a period of time, these gods dropped out of sight. And the whole idea of people and their gods, it turned into a metaphysical thing. You didn't see God, but we all know he's there. And then the priest caste, they were getting rich and powerful, you know, by representing God. God told me to tell you, here's how you're going to live. And they didn't want to give that up, so they built a whole system of catechisms and theologies and et cetera, et cetera. And so for the longest time, all the way up through the Middle Ages, the humans were pretty much governed by religion, okay? But with the advent of the printing press and with science and with the new turnover and the age of enlightenment, the power of religion began to wane, and they moved into finance.
Going to break in a moment. I just want to say you're doing a great job. Are you going to continue on with calls in the next hour?
You bet.
Blair, look who's going to be here with you. She's interviewing you on the nightly news tonight.
Oh.
Leanne Magadu.
Mars was just about to give the secret of the universe.
That's right.
And I just decided you've already been attacked by an alligator.
I thought it was Queen Elizabeth.
Yeah, Queen Elizabeth already barged in on you. But wait, needs a crown. So
yeah, so. Where's the crown?
You're going to break. I'm going to come back and take more calls. Would you like Leanne to co-host with you live?
Sure, absolutely.
He didn't ask to do that. I'm just kind of making it fun. This is your first time hosting live radio. You're an old hand at this. I thought I would make it as fun as possible.
Right.
Next, we're going to have monkeys swinging on chandeliers.
It'll be more fun if there's more people. The more...
I'm gone.
We're on the march. The empire's on the...
That's right. Too many of us owe our soul to the company store. I believe that was Tennessee Ernie Ford telling us about owe our soul to the company store. Okay, this is Jim Mars. We're back here on this last segment of the Alex Jones Show. And I got totally off in the left field trying to explain about how the secret society started. So I'll try to make this quick. After they, the key mechanisms for controlling humans have always been religion and then finance. And today it's mostly finance. But, if you've been keeping up with Alex, if you've been keeping up with some of the other people, the financial situation is getting very shaky. So, keep an eye on that because, you know, I think we're coming up on a time period that's going to make 2008 look like just a bump in the road. Let's move on and find out from more callers. Have we got a caller?
I think Chuck in Arizona was next.
Hey, Chuck in Arizona, are you there?
Hi, Mr. Mars. How you doing?
I'm tolerable.
Leanne, how are you?
Doing swell. Thank you.
Yeah, let me introduce Leanne McAdoo here.
I got thrown here in the hot seat with Alex Jones. He likes to. This is what this fourth hour is all about now. Surprises.
Actually, she's there, so you have something good looking to look at.
You've got the nice voice.
Okay, Chuck, what do you got?
Form? Will this be an overdrive form on YouTube?
I believe so. Yes.
Okay. Cool. Because that's the only way I get to watch you guys and listen to you guys. So real quick, I want to make 4 points. First one, most important. I think we need to have a push for national sovereignty. Every citizen needs to become a sovereign citizen. If you do this, it binds you to the Constitution, which is the law of the land. This, in turn, will hold the police's feet to the fire and make them act properly to make the judicial system work the way that it's supposed to work. Now, if you do that, we've always been told all problems start at home. If we start at the base program and we work our way up through the judicial system, we can further work our way up into politics to make these politicians act like they are supposed to act because they work for us.
Okay. So Chuck, you say that we need to become sovereign citizens and we need to vote on representatives who will actually represent us. And if they don't, then we need to vote them out and start all over again. And might I point out that that's not a radical idea. I hate to tell you, this is the way it's supposed to be. Okay. But it's gotten away from us. And so what you're saying is, and I totally agree, is that we need to go back to basics, which is we are all sovereign citizens and we're all operating together. And I also hear you about starting at a local level. This is most important. I've pretty much given up on the federal level. Washington is so corrupt, so bought and paid for that I think it's going to be near impossible to try to actually just change it around. What we can do is go to the local level. Get on the school board, get on the city council, get on the county commissioners. And then when the feds come along and say, okay, here's what you're going to do, just say no. Exactly. Right, Leanne?
Well, that's what we'd like to do. But I mean, here we've got the federal government just passing the House, voting on that Safe and Accurate Food Labeling Act. And they don't care that the states want safe labeling. They don't care that the states, you know, want GMO foods labeled.
Well, that's it. They ride roughshod over us on everything. And it's not necessarily always the feds. Up there near where I live in Denton County, some thoughtful people got together and they actually passed an ordinance saying they could not do any fracking in Denton County. And what happens? Governor Abbott of the state of Texas rams through a law that says you can't pass laws in locally that prevents business from doing things. You know, what about freedom and democracy? Is he not heard about?
Right. Or we got a Chris Christie saying if he becomes president, he's going to treat all of the diseased pot smokers with some federal law enforcement there. I mean, just totally bypassing the fact that states have voted on this, that medicinal marijuana, they're okay with it. So
that's like, right. And by the way, you can read about that in my new book, Population Control, because I kept a close eye on Washington State and on Colorado, where they have legalized not only medical marijuana, but recreational marijuana. And you know what? Guess what? Their taxes have the tax income, you know, their profits have gone sky high. Their traffic fatalities have dropped. Crime has dropped. It's obviously only the reasonable, prudent thing to do.
Hmm. Well, was all
right, that all? Ready for another
caller? Yeah. Let's go to the next caller. Who we got?
We've got Mark in California calling from KOMY 1340 AM. He'd like to discuss the Franklin cover-up.
Oh, boy. Okay, Mark, what have you got for us?
Well, I have Doug Millar for you. He's worked with the senator for 25 years, and there's only about 10 real heroes, and Doug Millar is one of them. He's like 77. He got arrested up there in Bohemian Grove. And the guy, Doug Millar, is just a wealth of information. And if you or Alex would like to interview him, he is available.
Okay.
All right. We can get his information from you after we get off the air.
There you go. Yeah, we're looking into anything and everything. And if this has to do with the Franklin cover-up, I might point out that this is a huge scandal going on in the UK right now, mm-hmm. about child pornography and child abuse. And they are trying to keep this as quiet as possible, but it needs to spread over here because going back to the Franklin cover-up and to all of these allegations that some of the most powerful people in this country are involved in child abuse and child pornography, this is serious enough. We need to start dealing with that, too.
Absolutely. It goes all the way to the top.
Okay. All right, do we have another caller?
Let's go to Dwayne in Wisconsin. He'd like to discuss population control.
Oh, population control. Perfect. That's my new book. Let's discuss that. What's on your mind, Dwayne?
Thank you, Mr. Mars. Real pleasure to have you hosting the show. Also, Leanne. I thought it was only fitting to title my little segment here, Population Control, as your new book is aptly titled. Just a couple quick things. I just wanted to run through a few things real quick, kind of rapid fire, and then you can give me your commentary on it. It's pretty clear our Second Amendment has shifted from the right to protect yourself from individuals and government to a means of destroying the Constitution. You know, it's just like being politically correct. You know, brainwashed people think it's about respect for others and, you know, not hurting people's feelings, but it really truthfully has a lot more to do with restricting our free expression of thoughts and killing the First Amendment. I mean, this is a hypothetical question, but how offended would the general public be if the Humane Society was caught harvesting kitten and puppy fetuses and selling the parts for profit? I see a lot more posts on Facebook about caring for animals and adopting them than I ever do about prenatal care for unborn children and adopting kids. Now, it comes down to this indoctrination, you know, through rampant implementation of thousands of sustainable development policies. Sustainable development, which of course is newspeak for Agenda 21. That Agenda 21, which Salon.com likes to call an Alex Jones construct. Well, if Agenda 21 is an Alex Jones construct, why is it cited by name in our Federal Register, Volume 63, Number 163, Monday, August 24th, 1998, under linkages to other initiatives?
Is that evidence and proof? Ugh, conspiracy.
Yeah, you've been doing your homework. how dare you hit them with facts?
Right.
By the way, it's really incredible to me over the years, all of this argument over birth control and particularly over abortion. What I find interesting is that most of the anti-abortion people who, number one, I feel like their heart is probably in the right place, but where's their mind? They seem very concerned about these unborn babies, and yet when these kids are born in the third world countries and in China and in Iran and in Iraq and in Afghanistan and in our own country, they don't seem to care about the ones who are already living and breathing. You know, in fact, the big dichotomy is that I think you'll find that most people who are anti-abortion are pro-death penalty.
Yeah.
So, you know, let's save the babies, but then if they turn out bad, well, we'll execute them.
Right. We have the Black Lives Matter protesters out there who were offended that we were daring to point out how many black babies are aborted by Planned Parenthood every year. And one of them actually said, "I kill my kids." So you're absolutely right about that. I mean, and actually they're not allowed to be called babies or fetuses or anything. They're called products of conception. That's what
Mars, you're a product of conception. We're going to chop you up.
I know. That's the Nazis did that. They call it retroactive birth control. But, you know, speaking of, okay, here, I got to tell you, my idea on abortion, that is a true controversy, and I call it a true controversy because I think there are equal numbers of thoughtful, caring, educated, knowledgeable people who simply cannot agree, okay, on when life starts and how important, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so why is there any problem? Freedom. Anybody ever heard that term? Freedom. You're free not to have an abortion. You're free to have an abortion. Nobody can make somebody do something else. It'd be up to the woman, to her doctor, to her family.
This is when the censorship begins.
Oh, but that's not politically correct, is it?
Not around you.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just teasing Mars.
Don't tell us how great abortion is. Now, listen, I get that for a lot of people, it is about having a child they can't take care of, but they got raped or they were doing drugs and are afraid it's going to be brain damaged or there's medical issues. The whole point is what's driving and promoting it, though, is the eugenics-based system.
Yes.
And so I don't want to hear about how, you know, cops kill, you know, however many black people every year. It's not even 100. It's terrible. Some of it's wrong. Sometimes, you know, they're in the wrong. Sometimes the cops are in the wrong. About these lives matter when then the blacks are being targeted for extermination, you know, with the whole Margaret Sanger deal. So that's my angle, separating those two. They make the whole compendium and the taxpayer funding of Planned Parenthood about, you know, a woman's choice. Well, then fine. Don't make me pay for it. You know, there's so many layers to this. Then it's not a federal issue. See, my hair's even sticking up. I don't even know I'd be in here.
Both of them.
Both of them. Look at both of them. Huh?
Oh, my anyway, goodness.
You like the new show, Leanne?
Fourth hour spiraling.
Can you put the slide on with Margaret Sanger and Hillary Clinton?
That's a hoax. Salon says it's a hoax. She's not
racist. It's not a hoax.
She loves the babies. It's a hoax.
Yeah, there we go. Margaret Sanger, the founder of Planned Parenthood, says colored people are like human weeds and need to be exterminated. And we find Hillary Clinton is a big supporter. I admire Margaret Sanger enormously, her courage, her tenacity, her vision.
Go to this.
So I guess Hillary has that same vision. Gator man here.
Gator me, baby.
Steve Irwin.
Liberal.
Steve Irwin.
Hillary Clinton's a guest today on the show.
Risen from the dead.
Feed me, Seymour.
What are you, racist against alligators? You afraid to have our first alligator president?
A trans alligator gender change.
You like the fourth hour?
Fourth
Anything
hour.
Can happen here.
Crazy fourth hour, I'll tell you. Come on, let's go. Is Dwayne still on the line?
Dwayne is no longer on the line.
Okay, who we got next?
Next, we have Robert in California. He'd like to discuss global elite mental illness.
Global elite mental illness.
They literally are mentally ill.
Yeah, that's true.
Years of inbreeding will do that to you.
That's exactly right. That's what happens when you go to those Bohemian Grove meetings. Okay, Robert, out in California, you're probably hot and dry out there. Tell us what's on your mind.
Yeah, all the chemtrails are just drying up all that water. Jim, Leanne, and Alex Jones in the background. My question is this. With all of our elites being crazy and wanting to kill us, and obviously our representatives are not representing us, and their mentality, they're unstable, being very questionable about that. Why are we playing footsies with crazy people?
Well, basically because they have their hands on the purse strings.
Mm-hmm.
But you're absolutely right. And that's why we need to get those people to step down. And we need to do something different. And like I said earlier, I'm not sure we're going to be able to do very much at the national level. But locally, you can see that people who think the same way you do, people who know the same things you do, get into office and start taking the steps necessary to straighten things up. In other words, you pack your city council with knowledgeable people who care about the health and safety of your community, and they're going to take a hard look at fluoridation and probably decide not to quit fluoridating the water and involuntarily medicating you.
Right, or even we have our governor here in Texas who stood up with this Jade Helm exercise and said, right, well, my constituents are concerned, so I'm going to go ahead and just make sure the National Guard keeps their eye on them. Make sure they're not violating their rights.
Exactly. And what really shocked me, well, not really, but considering the political correctness idiocy that's going on, but the reaction of people in the mass media and in the other parts of the country acted like some big terrible thing was going on. All Governor Abbott said was he was going to tell the Texas State Guard to just watch and monitor and see what they were doing. What's wrong with that? And that's only prudent, particularly when a good number of people are concerned about what's going on. And speaking of Jade Helm, have you noticed the wooden clog in the middle of it?
Yes. A lot of people wondering kind of what that is.
Well, I can tell you what that is, because having written a book called The Rise of the Fourth Reich, which is how the Third Reich, Nazis, were simply brought over here after the war, rolled into our military-industrial complex so that we would hopefully get our edge on the Russians, I immediately saw that wooden clog in the center of the Jade Helm 15 logo, and I immediately thought that the Nazi concentration camps, when you were sent in there, they put you in striped pajamas and gave you wooden shoes. So to me, it's a symbol of a concentration camp. And my question would be, why is there a symbolic thing of Nazi concentration camps on the official logo of this military exercise in the United States in 2015?
And that's interesting because it's transparent. It's a little hidden. It's almost like invisible.
It's almost like, here's a little hint for you.
Right. That you don't realize it's being built up all around you with the geospatial mapping and everything that we've gotten into as well.
Well, and of course, their logo says, Master the Human Domain. Whoa. What's the human domain? Just about
everything
anything to do
all.
With a human, right?
Absolutely.
And they're going to master it.
Yeah. Well on their way.
Yep. I hear music.
All right. Well, stick around.
We're almost
done.
Short
segment for you. Yep.
Hang in there, Leanne. You're doing great.
All right, folks. So this is the final segment. Take a few final calls. I want to thank Leanne McAdoo. I want to thank great Jim Mars, our wonderful crew, including Nico and the rest of the fine folks in there, like CJ and Wesley and just everybody. So great job. Have a safe weekend coming up, and we'll be back this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central. We got 5 minutes left of transmission. I leave you with Mr. Mars and Mr. McAdoo, our dynamic Scottish duo.
Ms. McAdoo.
Did I say Mrs.?
You said Mr.
Mr. McAdoo.
That's right.
That's the new conspiracy. Alex Jones admits Leanne is a man.
That's it. No way. You exposed it.
It's true. I am...
Bill Hicks, Rush Limbaugh is Jim Morrison, and you are?
Lee Mann.
I don't believe it. Ms. Leanne McAdoo. I don't think anybody's going to believe you're really a man.
They don't. It's not true, folks.
Tell them about your courage and just admit the truth.
And they're doing the work of two men, Laurel and Hardy. All right. We're back. We're going to take one more call. We're going to who?
Chris in North Carolina. He'd like to discuss the Georgia Guidestones.
Okay, Chris, what's on your mind?
Yes, sir. Thank you first and foremost for your service. I appreciate it. I serve too. And my question is I know they put 2015, I think it was 2015, block on the Georgia Guidestones, and I was wondering what you think about that, because Alex Jones has talked about how he feels in his gut some impending doom, and a lot of people have talked about it. But now they put it on the Georgia Guidestones, and, you know, R.C. Christian is just a face name for somebody else with New World Order. And I wonder what you think about it, because you're pretty much a big researcher on the Georgia Guidestones.
That's right. In fact, I cover the Georgia Guidestones here in my new book, Population Control. And, of course, what you find is the very first admonition is maintain human population on the world to 500 million. Well, again, right now it's 7.5 billion. So what are they going to do with the other 7 billion of us? And also, the fact that they put 2015 on there is only just adds to the accumulation of evidence that, I mean, you talk to some of the financial people, they say, get out of the stocks, you know, run for the hills. Mm-hmm. You hear military people going, you know, they are purging the U.S. military of people who are pro-Constitution. They're the Pacific Ring. The volcano activity, it's heightening up. The Yellowstone caldera is long past time that it could explode. I mean, there's so many, never mind asteroids coming in. Mm-hmm. There's just so much going on that it really is pretty creepy right now. And so I would advise keeping your eyes and ears open. And just as a matter of prudence, maybe there's a hurricane or maybe there's a tornado. Get yourself some food, some water, and have some supplies. Listen to Alex Jones. He tells it like it is. And he will keep you apprised as things start to happen. Okay, Leanne, tell us about the news tonight.
Well, first, I just wanted to say with the Georgia Guidestones, how bizarre that they always had that slot where something was going to be put, and then lo and behold, someone updated it this year with the 2015 stone.
Right.
That was bizarre because I never even had noticed that.
But. Well, and just like the rest of those stones, including this Mr. Christian who summoned them, it's all very mysterious. Nobody seems to know, and nobody seems to be able to tell us exactly what all this is. But it, to me, it's quite obvious that it ties into futuristic thinking.
Absolutely. Well, we're going to be talking about that on the news tonight, the Disclosure Project. So can't wait to get that out for everyone.
Disclosure. We're going to disclose. And that's disclose, not unclose. Okay,
tune
I hear
in.
The music. We're 7 heading out.
7 p.m. Central, the nightly news.
Leanne McAdoo,
I'll be
you
hosting
did a great job.
Mars.
Okay, Alex, you did a great job. We may keep you on.
We'll think about it.
Jim Mars.